Flags flying here at St James Park. We are 7 minutes away from kickoff, and the noise has just ramped up just that little bit more as the excitement grows as we await the two teams to emerge onto the field of play. We've got some breaking news from Italy. Juventus have been docked 10 points in Serie A following the verdict from the Federal Court of Appeal after their recent financial scandal. Initially, they were given a 15-point ban. That was suspended. As it stands, they're now seventh in Serie A, fallen outside of a European spot. Juve playing Empoli tonight. More on that, I'm sure, as the evening goes on and through the night in our sports bulletins on TalkSport. But what an atmosphere already at St James Park. Imagine this in the Champions League next season, and what a turnaround that has been. Last season, Newcastle bottom half finish, 22 points off the top four, and what a massive 49 points already. 20 points ahead of that total with two games left. Extraordinary stuff from Eddie Howe, which is why he is considered to be in the running for most people's manager of the season. And Leicester, Newcastle, I'll go back even further when I used to live in this part of the world and realise just how huge football was in this city, what it meant to the fans in this city as well. That was in the early 90s, and they were a game away from going down to the third tier. They went to Leicester, their opponents tonight, and needed a win to be sure, and they won 2-1 last minute. Own goal from Leicester's captain Steve Walsh, and the fans invaded the pitch and got the game stopped, and the 3 points belonged to Kevin Keegan. Fans opposite us have just unfurled a huge flag with Eddie Howe in animation form, and the players as well. Hard work pays off, dreams come true, bad times don't last, but legends do. And these players have the opportunity to make sure they go down as Newcastle United legends. Maybe not just finishing in the top four, but they've been to a cup final, remember, this season. What if they finally bring a trophy to St James Park after all the years without silverware? And what if they go further than they've ever done in the Champions League next season? Opportunity is there for Eddie Howe and the players to make history here at Newcastle United. Well, they need a point to guarantee it. They're as good as there given the goal difference, but a win would get this place absolutely rocking tonight. Kind of all started when I was talking about that game at Leicester. Kind of all started then with Kevin Keegan. Before then, yeah, they loved it. The Newcastle fans were brilliant. They weren't really packing out St James Park. Ozzy Ardiles was manager. They're playing some good football, but not winning football. And a few had lost heart. Keegan brought that back. And what, 4 years after that game at Leicester, they're challenging for a title they probably should have won, but actually blew it in the end. And Manchester United stole in Kevin Keegan, given his famous, now infamous, rant. He so nearly won the title here at Newcastle United. Could Eddie Howe possibly do that in the seasons to come? Well, out come the match officials, all in orange with black shorts, and out come Newcastle United, led by their player of the year, Kieran Trippier, Nick Pope behind him, and Leicester as well. Johnny Evans, the skipper, Everson, the keeper, and the rest of those Leicester City players. What a noise at St James Park. Get Ashley out and watch this club fly. That's what the fans kept telling us, and the fans were right. Newcastle are on the brink of bringing Champions League football back here to St James Park after a 20-year absence. For Leicester tonight, a win will mean their survival will be in their own hands on Sunday's final day, which we've got covered for you on TalkSport. Trouble is, Leicester do not win games. Big consequences on a big night on the world's biggest sports radio station, TalkSport. It is Newcastle against Leicester. It's former England defender Danny Mills alongside TalkSport's chief football commentator, Sam Matterface.
Newcastle's local heroes are so tantalisingly close. Leicester City, perilously so. in the most likely event of Champions League qualification and relegation. Ownerships will be questioned. Ownerships will be blamed. But what is a club in any case? Not the buildings or the directors or the people who are paid to represent it. It's not the television contracts, the get-out clauses, the marketing departments or executive boxes. It's the noise, the passion, the feeling of belonging, the pride in your city. It's a small boy clambering up stadium steps for the first time, gripping his father's hand, gawping at the hallowed stretch of turf beneath him, and without being able to do a thing about it, falling in love. The words of the great Sir Bobby Robson never seem more apt. Strap yourselves in, because only three teams can reach the two places in the promised land, Manchester United and possibly Newcastle. Well, they can secure theirs tonight. One of only Everton, Leeds and Leicester can survive. Leicester will find it difficult if they don't win. This is massive. As mentioned previously, there has been a late change to the starting lineup. Joel Linton is replaced by Elliot Anderson in midfield after Joel Linton got injured in the warm-up. Harrison Ashby is now on the bench for Newcastle United team, who start like this. Pope in goal, Trippier, Cher, Botman and Byrne, Bruno Guimaraes, Elliot Anderson and Longstaff in midfield, Almiron and Wilson up top, with Isak on the left-hand side. For Leicester, Everson, Sutar, Evans and Fass, the back three. The wing-backs, Castagna and Thomas, and Ndidi, Tielemans and Samare in midfield, Vardy and Ahia Nacho up top. Yes, Maddison and Barnes are here, they're just on the bench. Danny Mills is alongside me. The noise is, it's almost deafening, isn't it, really? But how does that affect the two sets of players on the pitch ahead of occasion they know both of them need to win?
It'd be quite easy to make Leicester very, very nervous and just ramp up that apprehension a little bit, add a little bit more tension to it. Newcastle are used to it. It's like this every single week. I think it will just make Leicester realise how much is at stake for them. And the way the team starts to be vital. The first goal is going to be vital. If Newcastle get that first goal, you start to worry for Leicester.
Enjoy the game.
Enjoy the game. Newcastle shooting from right to left towards the Leeds' end in black and white striped jerseys, the famous strip of this great club. Black shorts and black socks. Leicester all in blue, shooting from left to right towards the Gallagher in this first 45. And immediately, Alexander Isak gets a touch of the ball, his long, gangly frame, his excellent, exquisite skills that caused so much damage at Goodison Park a couple of weeks ago. He's running down that left touchline, getting to the byline, outpacing Castagna, and then Castagna puts the ball out off the swing. It goes behind and away for a goal kick away to our left-hand side. I think he had a shout for a corner there, Alexander Isak.
But what a start from Leicester. They've got the kick-off. They roll it back to Castagna, who smashes it straight into Isak. I mean, come on, you've got one job to launch it up the field and miss that one player. And he hits it straight. And sometimes that sort of sets the tone, doesn't it? Because Jamie Vardy's now thinking, I can't believe he's done that. How you managed to do that? And all of a sudden, you're on the back foot. Little things make big differences.
Referees Andre Mariner, Dan Cook, Scott Ledger, the assistants, Craig Pawson, the fourth, and the VAR is Darren England. Remember, on Wednesday night, we've got live Premier League coverage of the champions against the new Europeans. Next weekend, three playoff finals for you on the TalkSport network, and all the final day drama. And we've got all the finals, the FA Cup final, the Europa League final, the Conference League final and the Champions League final, all on TalkSport. We're here at St James' Park. We've played just over a minute and a half, and it is Newcastle United 0, Leicester City 0. Eddie Howe stalking around inside the technical area down in front of us. There is a smattering of Leicester City support, nearly 2,000, about 1,700 who have made the journey up in the top of the Leeds' end, right up high behind the goal that they are currently defending. Sent long by Everson, headed forward by Cher, and then tossed up into the air towards the Leicester goal. It's away by Evans before it causes any danger and runs through to Kieran Trippier. Picked up by Bruno Guimaraes, immediately wraps the ball into Wilson. The offside flag goes up. And it's very much a back five, isn't it, for Leicester City? That's how they look when they haven't got the ball. And so far, Newcastle have had the most of it.
It's a back five with three sitting midfield players in front of them. It's very, very defensive.
So far from it being a back seven, which you said, it's a back eight.
it's not far off it, in all honesty, when you look at it. You know, it's three narrow centre-halves, two deep wing-backs.
That needs must for Leicester City, who know their situation is precarious. Yahia Nacho back in the team after a groin injury, which he sustained against Leeds United while setting up a goal for Jamie Vardy. Live on TalkSport. Newcastle 0, Leicester City 0. Newcastle were terrific on Thursday. They smothered Brighton right from the off here, stopping them playing out from the back, disrupting their passing lanes. They face a bit of a different prospect, I suppose, today in Leicester City. They won't come onto them. They will sit back and hope that maybe Jamie Vardy can get in behind the Newcastle defence. A Newcastle defence that has found clean sheets harder to come by than earlier in the season. And just a little bit of a mistake there. And when the ball was played crossfield by Botman out towards Trippier, and it went right over his head, and Trippier then turned round to everyone and went, "Hey lads, just calm down." Ball sent down the left channel. Out comes Pope to the edge of his penalty area, collects it and immediately bowls it out over to the far side and finds Kieran Trippier. Anderson wants it near side. It's coming towards him now. He takes it into his body and runs up over halfway. He plays it into the feet of Isak, who's about 3 yards in from the left touchline, cuts into the middle of the pitch, opens it up, gives it back to Trippier. Chance to send the ball down the right touchline. Miggy Almiron picks it up, plays it against the defender, claims the handball, but it goes out for a corner over on the far side, the first of the game for the home team, Newcastle United. Goalless on TalkSport.
I just love the way that Kieran Trippier's technique, the way he passes the ball, it never bobbles it into people. It's always on the floor so they can play it first time.
150th Premier League appearance for Kieran Trippier tonight. Most assists for Newcastle this season. Right footed, delivers a deep cross towards the far post. Dan Byrne, who scored with a header the other night, heads the ball down and into Wilson. It comes back out the left side of the penalty area, and then Bruno Guimarães takes it back to halfway, and Longstaff will keep things moving. It'll be good for Eddie Howe to see Longstaff back in the team as Trippier drips it forward again, left by Byrne, taken down by Scher, but Byrne got in his way. It's cleared upfield for Jamie Vardy, who's tussling with Botman on the halfway line. Botman sandwiches his body between ball and man and steers it back to his goalkeeper, Nick Pope. Good defending by Botman, who's been a really good acquisition, actually nominated for the Young Premier League Player of the Year. Only 23 years of age. He said a month ago that they would finish in the top four. It looks as if he's going to be proved right. They only need a point in order to do that. Here is Longstaff, back from injury, sends the ball out towards the near side. Anderson takes it on, runs square, midway inside the Leicester half of the field. Bruno Guimarães opens up the pitch to Trippier, lovely ball in towards Wilson. It flicks off his head, actually ducked out of the way, hit him on the back of the head and went into the air, and it was garnered up by Daniel Everson. Away to our left hand side. Late change to the starting lineup. Joel Linton had to be replaced by Elliot Anderson, and as a result of that, Harrison Ashby, who they picked up from West Ham United, is sitting on the bench tonight. And Leicester know that all 3 points will remarkably take them out of the relegation zone. They also know they can't be relegated tonight. Defeat means it's almost certain that they will be. They would need to win, hope Everton lose and Leeds fail to win on the final day, should they end up being defeated here this evening. No Barnes and Maddison in the starting lineup. And although we've sort of thought from the beginning, really, the premise of the attack for Leicester City will be get the ball over the top for Vardy to chase. Actually, one of the major supply routes to Vardy are those balls from Maddison and Barnes. Here's Isak down the left-hand side to the back edge of the penalty area, through the six-yard box, cleared away by Luke Thomas. Good run by Isak again. Anderson takes over, sends it back towards the edge of the box, right-footed ball into the area, away by Johnny Evans this time. He volleys it out towards the near touchline. Byrne can't keep it in. Apparently there was a touch on that, and it's going to be a Leicester City throw. I was just about to say, Danny, that the supply routes to Vardy usually come from Barnes and Maddison, and actually trying to find those balls to thread them behind the Newcastle defence might be more difficult when you've got the likes of Samare, Ndidi and Tielemans in midfield, especially Tielemans not on the best of form.
Well, you want to be playing those balls from sort of round about the edge of the D in your own half, edge of the centre circle, that D. You know, so it's a 30-yard pass. At the moment, they've hit four long balls from the centre-half position.
here on the right side. Almiron for Newcastle, chasing into the penalty area. Longstaff turns, fires it back to Guimaraes, plays it down the right. Longstaff goes down, being wrestled by Luke Thomas. It looked naive and a little bit clumsy. And Longstaff went down, didn't appeal too much, which sort of suggests there might not have been too much in it.
I think wrestle was a slight exaggeration, I think. I think it's good defending. It's just blocked off, look. There's no way you're going to get a penalty for that. Never in a million years.
His left arm came out and he just sort of pushed him to the floor, didn't he?
No.
Not going to get a penalty for it, but it,
no.
It's...
The rule says you don't have to get out of the way as a defender.
More than a tickle. I wouldn't like to be pushed like that. Newcastle United, I'm a big softie though.
Yeah,
Newcastle.
I think you need to get in the gym more then.
I was in there today, actually.
Yeah, but you have to do stuff when you're in there. Not just sit on the machine and have a coffee.
I was going to say, sitting in the cafe is not the same thing, no. Yellow card has come out for Bruno Guimaraes for a challenge on Samare over on the far side, wiring into a tackle on the midfielder. The first yellow card of the game. That didn't take long for Andre Mariner to get his card out. 8 minutes gone. It was a bit high and it was right on the knee, and actually could have been in a little bit more trouble, actually, in fairness.
It's nasty, it's missed time.
Oh, dear, oh dear. I wouldn't be too surprised if there was a VAR check.
I think VAR should look at it. I mean,
oh dear.
I was at the Liverpool game at the weekend.
So he's missed the ball and he's put his studs onto the top of the knee.
Yeah, and there's more force in that. So the one at the weekend for Liverpool.
On Gakpo.
Yeah, I think Mings is trying to pull out of that. He wins the ball first. And then he tries to put his legs away. You can't referee by outcome. You can never, ever do that. That's always a very, very dangerous thing to do.
And your suggestion is there, because there was blood drawn, they overplayed it.
Yeah, everyone gets a bit mortified. When you look at what Mings wins the ball, he pulls his foot away. This one, he goes in with a straight leg, misses the ball, and that's the difference. A straight leg means...
Is there enough force in it? Does it look worse in slow motion, and actually it wasn't as bad as that in full speed?
If it had been in red, would someone have overturned it? Probably not, is the answer.
Well, maybe Bruno Guimaraes has got a little bit fortunate. Early set piece then for Leicester over on the far side. Right footed, swings the ball towards the edge of the penalty area, Tielemans. It's away by Cher, back in by Thomas, but it's not a very good delivery. He's just sort of volleyed that, hit and hope style. And it's picked up by Nick Pope and sent out towards the near touchline. And it's with Dan Byrne. Dan Byrne has it. Just a couple of yards in from the left touchline. He slides it across to Fabian Cher. And then they start building down the right-hand side. Infield they go to Wilson. Wilson trying to turn. He moves the ball out towards the left, and now it's with Byrne. Byrne onto Anderson. 10 yards short of the Leicester penalty area. Wider on to Isak. Isak, slender of build, into Dan Byrne. Anything but big, tall and muscular. Plays it centrally into Botman. Botman to Cher, who strides over the halfway line. Good patient football from Newcastle United, who are building up through the middle of the pitch now, out towards the right, and Almiron, who is fouled by Luke Thomas. Free kick, tight to the touchline, far side for Newcastle United. 0-0.
Very defensive, very negative so far from Leicester. Not really closing down particularly with any ferocity, allowing Newcastle plenty of the ball. I mean, this might be quite bold, but they look like a team waiting to get beat at the moment.
That is the exact same phrase that Danny Murphy used last Monday night for the game against Liverpool.
Oh, sorry, I wasn't listening either. Sorry.
It's exactly what he said. Almiron over on the far side, taking the free kick, right footed, deep towards the far post. They're queuing up, it's away by Evans, chested down by Elliot Anderson, who gets it onto his right foot, keeps the ball in play well, actually, despite harassment. It's sent down towards the right, and that's a poor challenge by Tielemans, but it's run through to Almiron, and they're going to be allowed to play on. The crossing towards the near post, headed away by Wout Faster. Under pressure here, Leicester City, in the early stages, live on TalkSport, 11 minutes gone. Ball out of play, far side, throw into Newcastle. Guimaraes back to the wide right, and Cher, who charges forward. He's run into the edge of the box. He's laid it off towards Anderson, who's encouraged to shoot. Instead, he threads it forward, looking for Isak. It was a little bit ambitious to try and play that sort of pass. He gave it straight to Castagna, and it's cleared away to halfway. But they come again, they've got possession once more over on the far side. There's an intensity and a tempo to Newcastle that there isn't about Leicester City.
Leicester, you're right, Sam, there's no intensity whatsoever. No one's getting close to the ball, no one's putting pressure on. It's almost like, well, if the ball comes to me, I'll clear it. If it doesn't, I won't bother making an effort.
Isak into Guimaraes, got it back again, and Isak couldn't take it into his body. It's clear to halfway. There's no one to get hold of the ball. There's no out ball whatsoever. They're so deep that there's no one in front of them. And Iheanacho and Vardy are just chasing around like shadows, because it is basically eight players and then the two up top.
But again, the ball switched. No one has moved, not a single Leicester player has moved. It's like you get lulled into a false sense of security. Because what happens is you're all back behind the ball and you think, oh, we're all behind the ball, we're safe. But nobody's actually picking up. No one's making sure players are marked. It's way too easy for Newcastle at the moment.
Dominating possession, 76% of it so far in the game. They're down the right side on the attack with Almiron, who gets towards the angle of the penalty area. Joe's over the ball and tries to get away from Wout Fass, who's at least showing a little bit of fight over there, chasing him out there. Oh, he skipped past another challenge, past Tamare, kept hold of the ball well, and he moves towards the midpoint of the Leicester half. Isak loses the ball, and Vardy now looks to counter-attack. Isak comes from behind, knocks him to the floor, runs it back, and Vardy screams and shouts. The free kick is given to Leicester City. Elliot Anderson, using the gamesmanship skills honed on the training ground, picks up the ball and delays the taking of any free kick.
And why not? Exactly what he should be doing. It's not dark arts, it's professionalism.
Absolutely. Look, listen, that is something that they've learned very quickly here, and it's something that Eddie Howe sort of employed down at Bournemouth, but it went under the radar a little bit. He went off to Atletico Madrid and spent a bit of time there during his sabbatical and picked up even more from Diego Simeone, things he could use. And they've done it. But it's not just about that. They've played some brilliant football as well. They've got some great goal scorers, and they're putting the pressure on Leicester City here. Here is Longstaff down the right. A roll by Almiron. He beats Luke Thomas. He goes into the right wing position, lays it off to Longstaff, who's been chased out there by Wout Fass. He's played it against Thomas, who's coming back. And it's out for another corner away to our right hand side. It's all Newcastle.
I mean, Leicester have been in the Newcastle half once with any, I would say, control on the ball. There's been a few launches forward that have come to absolutely nothing. But like I said, they're defending at the moment, and it feels a little bit like, well, if it hits me or is close to me, I'll clear it. But I'm not going to make a huge effort to get anywhere else.
0-0 the score. 14 and a half minutes gone, live on TalkSport on game night. And it's a corner over on the far side to be taken by the arch set piece taker, Trippier, in towards the near post, flicked away by Harry Suter, out towards this near side, and Elliot Anderson scurries to retrieve it for Newcastle, back centrally, and Guimaraes, lovely ball in towards Wilson, he almost got there. It was a brilliant ball through the eye of a needle for Bruno Guimaraes. It split that tightly packed Leicester defence in two, and Wilson was on it. Look at that run and movement from Wilson as well, the way he checks back to make sure he's onside, then darts into position down the left channel. And if he'd got on the end of that and rounded the goalkeeper, that would have been a certain goal.
Perfect centre-forward play. Come towards the ball, two or three steps, turn and spin. Make sure you stay onside, and a fabulously weighted ball from Guimaraes was inches away from being perfect.
How good is Kieran Trippier? Just picked the ball up over on the far side under a little bit of pressure, so switched it from right to left into Byrne, who was free. Oh, how good is Isak? He's torn Castagna a new one down the left-hand side. Played a good ball into Anderson inside the box. Played it against Johnny Evans, and then it popped up against him and then went out of play for a goal kick. But Isak's having a field day down this left-hand side. Couple of little step-overs and tricks which have easily taken him past Timothy Castagna, who can't live with him at the moment. And that was excellent from the Swedish attacker.
You've got so many problems like that when you're the fullback, and already he's got him on toast.
Who's done that to you?
Ginola.
Yeah?
Villa? I think it was at Spurs.
Okay.
But it's one of those, it's like, because if I was Isak now, I'd be in the fullback's ear going, you know what, I've got you. What are you going to do about it? Because in this day and age, you can't fail. You can't go and put a massive challenge in to stop him. And you just keep on, say, what, you know, just. Oh, there you go again, look, he's just running in behind him.
Oh, Wilson, he's got the better of Suter. He's gone into the penalty area now. He tries to tease it towards the far post. It wasn't the best of efforts and it was cleared away. I think everyone was shocked, actually, that the ball came through to Wilson, even Callum Wilson himself. He's got a grimace on his face. But it feels like a matter of time.
They're enjoying themselves, Newcastle, at the moment.
Just a bit. It's 0-0. But they've had all the ball. Yeah. 80% possession now.
Even Isak there, where it didn't quite work out. They looked at each other, had a little smile, a little giggle to each other. It's like, this is good. We're enjoying this. No chance. We're going to get that point, at least. And probably more the way they're playing.
TalkSport live at St James's Park with Almiron on the attack again for Newcastle. Down the right-hand side, moving into the penalty area. Gets it back onto his left foot, runs inside the box, left-footed. Drives it towards the far corner. It's over the top of the crossbar. It's a good effort from Miguel Almiron after a really good run. And he's had a difficult time, really. Only 3 goals in his last 25 after a brilliant start to the season in goal-scoring terms.
Well, he was ahead of Jack Grealish, wasn't he, at one point? Yeah. You know, getting all the plaudits. Obviously, Jack's kicked on since then, and all credit to him. But I think what you do have here with this Newcastle side, it's a very good organisation and a fantastic team work ethic. Mm. You know, they are very much a team.
And you see that with all the way they celebrate after games when they've won, the pictures, the collective group celebrations. I was here on Thursday night. They started that game so well. They bossed the midfield, which was the first time they managed to do that in the absence of Longstaff. And he's back in the team today.
It is a lot easier doing that and having a great spirit when you're winning, I have to say that.
But they weren't winning last season. Not as much as they are now. I mean, when Eddie Howe took over, they were relegation
That's credit to Eddie Howe and his staff and the players that he's brought in. But he's brought in those characters that not only have won, but are able to create that mentality of good characters working hard, being together.
Listen, let's not pretend they haven't spent loads of money. They've spent good money on good players, but they've also coached some of the players that were here made them better.
Yeah, but they haven't spent extortionate amounts of money compared to everybody else in and around them.
19 minutes play. Newcastle 0, Leicester 0. Live on TalkSport. That's a little bit loose from Trippier. Goes straight to Ndidi. And then on to Tielemans, who travels forward, clips the ball over the top, looking for Iheanacho. Byrne got a little bit tangled there. Iheanacho has kept hold of the ball. And then he's been pushed backwards by Byrne. Into midfield it goes. Samare back to Johnny Evans. And Newcastle push them back into their own half. Harry Suter has it. Clips it down the right touchline. Botman away, heads it into Burns' path. First time ball goes past Ndidi. Anderson, now Bruno Guimaraes is on it again. He clips it wide right. There's space here for Trippier. He runs forward. The Leicester defence are backpedalling. Trippier's coming forward. He's now midway inside their half. He plays it forward towards the edge of the box, and there's a bit of a late challenge by Longstaff on Johnny Evans. It was a coming together of the two, according to the referee, but Johnny Evans, who has only just come back from a very lengthy injury, doesn't look particularly comfortable after that collision.
Dead leg. Nothing more than that, really. Johnny Evans comes across and clears it.
Oh, is it not the knee on the...
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. It's a knee into the face, a dead leg. It's just like you said, Sam, it's just a coming together. There's nothing you can do about that. He's slowing down, he's stopping. He just catches him. It'll be a sore one for Johnny Evans. He's going to have to keep stretching that, keep that warm. If not, that is going to tighten up very, very quickly.
Leicester City have scored the 10th most goals in the league over the course of the season. Only Leeds, Southampton and Bournemouth have conceded more. As Dean Smith said yesterday, disappointment and frustration are the two words I'd say I've seen. But we are running out of games to put that right, and the players know that. Yep, it's now or never for Leicester. Newcastle just need a point to secure Champions League football. So, as it stands right now, they're all right. Byrne moving up to halfway. Newcastle dominating the ball. A lovely tifo came up prior to the start of the game with the old school Newcastle badge away to our left in the Leeds' ends, which I thought was terrific. Ball sent wide.
Look at Trippier and Byrne are just playing like 1-2s with each other across the back, aren't they? But the ball's travelling 60 yards and not a single Leicester player is going to close down.
Isak has seen a lot of the ball in the early exchanges, plays it back into midfield. Guimaraes wide, on to Byrne, back to Bruno Guimaraes, who leaves it for Elliot Anderson, who sizes up an effort, right footed towards the far corner. Iversen has to take a couple of steps to his left in order to get there. He does, and it goes into the arms of the Danish goalkeeper and it will be cleared away. But that was good football from Newcastle United, manipulating the ball across the line. It's a tightly packed defence, it's going to be difficult to break down, but they've had a couple of efforts already.
But it looks like one of those games, training games, where it's youth team versus the first team, and the youth team has said, don't get too tight, don't tackle anyone, don't get anybody injured, just be in the way and let them have the ball. Where's the pressure?
Everybody's behind the ball, but there's not a single bit of pressure on any Newcastle player.
Trippier on the right side delivers a ball into the box. It's flicked away by Suter. Where's the pressure? It's on the Leicester City shoulders. Castagna on the right side of their defence brings it clear up towards halfway, then launches it high down the right channel. Nick Pope's going to come and get that. He heads it delicately into the path of Bruno Guimarães, and they're off and underway again. Newcastle coming through the middle up to Trippier. They're allowed to pass the ball around. Dean Smith says he should have shaped that ball, Timothy Castagna. Why didn't he? By which time, they're already on the edge of the Leicester penalty area. Guimarães into Longstaff, inside the area. Left footed shot, blocked by Evans, inside the 6-yard box. It'll come through towards Izak. They're playing on despite of a handball. He's gone down the side of the penalty area. He's twisting away from one defender. Plays it against Castagna. Plays it against him again.
Another handball.
And it's away for a corner.
It was a second-hand ball there, I think.
I think it was outside the box, wasn't it?
Well, but, be close, but his arm was high as well. I'm not sure. I know Andrew Mann is trying to play on, but when you've got Kieran Trippier in your side and a free kick potentially at 22
yards. I thought it wasn't much of an advantage sending him down a cul-de-sac, was
it?
Well,
yeah, I'd rather have the free kick.
Corner kick has been given. On this near side, the Newcastle left as they look at it. It's a huge bunch of players in front of the goalkeeper, Daniel Everson. And there's a bit of space on the edge of the area for Almiron and for Anderson, of which there's only one Leicester City marker. And this corner to be taken by Trippier on this near side. He hits it right-footed in towards that congested near post. It's headed away by Vardy. Comes back to Longstaff, who's in front of the centre circle. He clips it over the top towards the right side. It's flicked away and then picked up by Cher, far side. He travels with it, plays it to the right edge of the area. It's a 1-2 from Almiron and Bruno Guimarães. He gets caught under his feet. Thomas does well to scrap the ball away. They dig it out and send it long, but of course it goes straight to a black and white shirt, and it comes back again. Down the right, Cher travelling forward. 24 gone, TalkSport runs into Samare, turns it over, he looks up, where can he pass the ball to? Well, he can't pass it now because he's been dragged to the floor by Fabian Cher.
What did I say Leicester's tactics would be before the game? Pack the defence and launch it. And that's exactly what's happening, isn't it?
Is it working?
It's 0-0, so they're in the game. And this is, Dean Smith's game plan would have been, you know what, let's stay in the game. If we can get a bit lucky, keep a clean sheet, whatever it might be, there's always a chance with the pace that we have up front, with Vardy, with Iheanacho, that we can nick one on the counter-attack.
Newcastle already have more points than any other Premier League season for 20 years, when Bobby Robson was blending youth and experience with a cool hand. Amiobi and Shearer, Genus and Speed, Bramble and O'Brien interspersed with Woodgate, Solano and Dyer. Now it's a new team, and there will be new faces that want to join this project in the summer. It's a special time to be a Newcastle fan. And the point tonight takes them to the promised land of the Champions League. And Europe itself is new ground, the first European tour since the Alan Pardew days. Just a point needed tonight for top tier stuff, but they've already guaranteed a place in the Europa League next season, at bare minimum.
Just a word on Eddie Howe as well, though. When you think, you know, he's earned his stripes coming through the ranks.
Absolutely.
You know, finishing very, very early, taking a coaching managerial role extremely early, and working his way up through the system, and has now got to the very, very top level. I know he's young, but he's actually very experienced, isn't he, for a young manager?
Absolutely. I've spent a lot of time with Eddie because he was injured for a large part when I was a rookie reporter down on the south coast. Here is Izak playing the ball towards the left-hand side. And that's a late challenge on Castagna by Izak, and he's going to get a yellow card. He's gone down and hurt himself, and now, or is he tying his laces? No, I think he's hurt his calf, has he there?
No, I think he's just caught his knee. I think it's one of those. As he's stretching, it's just caught his shin. And the problem is, they don't wear shin pads these days. You know, that's the issue, isn't it? They're so small, they're so tiny.
I think we should probably explain to listeners what you mean by that, because if you go into a kit room at a training ground, there's a special regulation about how big the shin pads have to be.
It's about iPhone size.
Yeah, and the players have them cut to exactly that, don't they? To make sure that they're as light as possible on the front of their shins.
Which, again, it just goes to show there is almost zero contact in the game.
And that's the other problem, I think. There becomes, and I spoke to a lot of the rugby guys about this, there becomes a point where maybe the players are feeling a little bit more because they're not used to contact. They're not used to getting clipped. They're not used to getting that shin on shin and getting up and playing on. But yeah, you're right. If a phone's bigger than an iPhone, I mean, you'd be very, very surprised. Sorry, shin pads are bigger than an iPhone. You'd be very, very surprised.
I was going to say, if a phone's bigger than an iPhone, then it's probably a Samsung Galaxy, isn't it?
Other phones are available.
This is Talk Sport. You're not listening to the phone shop. And we're live.
He's struggling here, isn't he, Sam, though?
Well, he's down and he's getting some treatment and we've got a pause in play. And as a result of that, all the players are taking on fluids to make sure they're hydrated. I thought it was pretty warm and humid today, actually. It's a bit of a dehydrating day. You're listening to Newcastle versus Leicester on TalkSport with Now Sports. Don't forget, we're Now Sports. You can stream all the Sky Sports action like Newcastle versus Leicester live right now for £11.99. Search Now Sports. And let me tell you what's coming up this week. Brighton Manchester City on Wednesday night is live on TalkSport. That's basically like a party, right? I wouldn't be surprised if like Norman Cook's there, DJ, and while the game's going on. Those two teams have achieved everything they need to achieve
this
season.
He'll be down the front, mate. Don't worry about that. He won't be in the stadium.
Manchester United-Chelsea is Thursday night. That's live on Talk Sport. Saturday, we got Coventry-Luton, the Championship playoff final. Live and exclusive. Looking forward to that. 4:45 that one starts. Sunday, Carlisle-Stockport, the League Two playoff final. And then at 4:30, we'll have two, three, four, five games for you on the Talk Sport network. We won't decide yet where we're going until we know what the state of play is, but we will let you know in the fullness of time. Monday it's Barnsley Sheffield, Wednesday in the League One playoff final at 3 o'clock, and then Wednesday night Sevilla against Roma in the Europa League final. Looking forward to that, and then the Manchester derby Saturday 3rd of June, the FA Cup final, Conference League final and Champions League final to come. All the football all the time. It's Talk Sport. We're back underway, and so is Alexander Isak back on the field of play after his treatment, and he's moving. Leicester City are on the attack down the left-hand side. It's clipped in towards the near post. I think there might have been a hand used there. It's going to be a free kick to Newcastle in the right full-back position. 0-0.
When you say on the attack, you mean in Newcastle's half?
Sorry, yeah. Geographically, yeah. On the attack. Floodlights are on, and the Newcastle fans haven't stopped singing since... They all crammed in here about half an hour before kickoff. They brilliantly whipped the atmosphere up now inside this stadium. It is great to be here.
The only thing that's annoying is the PA system that is so loud. And I say that because it's unnecessary.
Do you know what? PA systems get on my nerves.
They don't need
They're
it.
They're either too loud or they don't work properly. Yeah. Yesterday at Manchester City, just didn't work properly. They're in interviews on the pitch. You couldn't hear a word they were saying.
If there's one place where you do not need to ramp up the atmosphere, it's here.
Ball in towards the Leicester City box from the right-hand side by Wilson. Dealt with by Castagna. Burns shoots from miles out. Hits the first man and then is won by Jamie Vardy in midfield. He sends it up, plays a 1-2 with a Iheanacho. Longstaff's going to get there ahead of Jamie Vardy. Turn the ball over and now Newcastle on the attack again. Half an hour played at St James's Park on this Monday night. Game night on TalkSport. It's on to the left and Anderson by Isak. He tries to get beyond Castagna. Gives it back to Isak. A chance to cross. Who's he waiting for in the centre? Burns travelled in there. Here's Guimaraes trying to steer it through towards Burn. He couldn't keep it under control. It bounces off him and Samare leaves it for Ndidi, who brings it clear. Then Tielemans whips it round the corner, inviting Iheanacho to chase. He's fast, but not that fast. And Nick Pope has it just outside his own penalty area, away to our right-hand side. Newcastle United in possession again.
It's a dangerous thing to say, and it's not a very nice thing to say, but Leicester look like they've lost all hope.
Madison and Barnes were left on the bench tonight because they've become too easy to play against, says Dean Smith. Here's Anderson outside the D, playing it towards the left. Isak takes it on, gets it onto his right foot, shoots, but gets maybe a little bit too much on that. Almost ended up being a bit of a toe poke, actually, from Isak. And as a result of that, it flew away beyond the far post and out into the Leeds' end and away for a goal kick. 81% possession for Newcastle United. Four shots on goal, one on target, three corners. Leicester's figures, 19% possession, no shots on target, no corners.
And only giving away two fouls, which means they're not getting tight to anybody. They're not putting pressure on the ball, because you would expect a team defending for their lives
would be overstepping the mark on occasion, and they're clearly not even doing that.
Well, they still remain the only team in Europe's major leagues not to keep a clean sheet post the World Cup, Leicester City. Byrne plays it straight against Ndidi. Ball's blocked. Jason Tindall with a bit of control on the near side. Just on his phone then, Jason Tindall. Just put it back into his pocket. Still never beat the Sam Allardyce trick yesterday of finding a fiver, offering it around to everyone, and then casually putting it in his pocket. That was terrific. That was all going well at that point for Sam Allardyce until...
Surely Jason Tindall was just taking a selfie, wasn't he?
He's a good lad, Jason Tindall.
I'm just jealous. He's got a very fine head of hair, a lovely tan.
He really has. He's got enough hair for the both of us, I think.
Not sure where that tan comes from in Newcastle, though.
I am. Here's Castagna on the near touchline, down the right, looking for Ndidi. Ball into the air, and Bruno Guimarães has a little bit of poise by nudging it forward to Wilson. Leicester, who are defending very deep, now have to deal with Almiron. That's a good touch. He's turned and he's run at the tightly packed defence. He runs into Suter, gets an arm in the face, and Andre Mariner doesn't give a free kick. Looks as if he was looking for that Almiron.
He was going down before he got the knock in the face, and I think he did get a knock in the face, but I think because he was already on the way down, the referee makes the right call.
Trippier, far side, the right. Still 0-0. 12 minutes before half-time. Here's Elliot Anderson on the left-hand side. It's very tiring when you haven't got the ball for so often in the match. Izak in towards the near post. So it's stabbed towards his own goal by Evans, who eventually runs it out towards the near side and manages to clear. And it was a delicate little ball in by Izak. It was a really teasing ball, which Evans had to deal with. Here's Iheanacho dropping deep. And Leicester trying to get out. Newcastle harassing them. They find a way to find Ndidi, whose ball over the top is headed away by Cher. And it's picked up again by Newcastle United. They've got nowhere near Nick Pope's goal, by the way, in this game. Leicester City, maybe that's the plan.
They're just hoping for one ball over the top, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're going to keep trying it. They're going to sit deep, defend, well, put themselves behind the ball. Not quite sure you can call it defending. And they're just going to launch it forward and hope that Vardy gets onto something or Newcastle player slips over.
And they've got a goal threat, Newcastle United. 18 goal, Callum Wilson. Isak's got 10, both create two. Almiron's got 11, Bruno's got 5. Here is Trippier into the box looking for Anderson. It's a bit behind him and it's away by Castagna. And he clears out towards the near touchline and he runs upfield towards halfway for Leicester. Clips it over the top looking for Iheanacho. And he almost got something on it. But across comes Cher in front of Vardy. Puts it out for a throw-in over on the far side. 0-0. Dean Smith claps and applauds the effort from Leicester City, who have worked hard in the opening 35 minutes of the game.
And breaking news, Leicester and Newcastle's half.
And Luke Thomas is going to take the throw-in over on the far side.
There's no urgency from Leicester at all, is there?
Nope. Run the clock down. Let's see how far we can get with a scoreline that reads Newcastle 0, Leicester City 0 on TalkSport with Car Finance 24-7. Behind you on your car buying journey, search Car Finance 24-7 today. Ball headed away by Newcastle, picked up by Wilson, smacked into the air by Anderson. Launched to halfway, Evans nudges it forward. It's over the head of Longstaff, and Kieran Trippier can take a couple of touches before sending it into midfield for Bruno Guimarães, who shapes the ball through the air out towards the near side. Dan Byrne takes it down, wants to run up towards the halfway line. Just got outfoxed by the spin of the ball. Then sends it back to Bruno Guimarães, and then it's infield to Fabian Cher. Cher wide onto Trippier, who's got space to run into down the right side. He's midway inside Leicester territory now, on the attack for Newcastle United. Wide on the touchline again now. Trippier gets it back from Bruno Guimarães. He then turns infield. Needs to be a little bit more movement from the Newcastle forwards. Here is Cher out to Anderson on the near side. Back to Botman. Into Bruno Guimarães. Longstaff, Cher far side once again. 37 gone. Trippier slides it through up to the edge of the area. Bruno Guimarães dives in. Wilson will get there. No, he won't, because Harry Suter comes lumbering out. He's big and physical and chunky, and he smacks the ball to halfway. Australian international Harry Suter, who hasn't been used that much by the new manager, Dean Smith. Brendan Rodgers was using him a bit, but he's a very big, bulky defender. He's got a real physical presence about him. He's strong and very aggressive. He did very well at the World Cup. Here on the left-hand side, Isak trying to take the ball down the touchline. He comes infield instead and gives it to Botman. They switch the ball to the far side, quickly touched on to Trippier. Trippier down the right. Longstaff gets a nudge in the back. I thought that was a foul.
It's a foul.
That is a foul.
It's a clear foul, that. Not quite sure why Andrew Mann has missed that one.
Guimaraes travels forward. He needs some support. He's got Isak to his left. He gives it to him eventually. He comes centrally. It's very tightly packed in the middle of the pitch. They need to get the ball wide here, Newcastle United. Open up the pitch, stretch that back line. Guimaraes delivers a ball into the box. Almiron is peeling away, heads it down, finds Trippier inside the area, sets it back, headed away by Suter. Comes back towards the edge of the box and just swings a foot at it, and it just goes into the Leeds' end, into the second section of seats. And then a steward tried to kick it and then fell on his backside.
That's why you're a steward. Let the lads do the playing. Trying to do a half volley off the steps is never a good idea, is it? But Newcastle, so dominant. They just need that goal. They just need that breakthrough. They get one, they'll get three or four, I think, the way that it's going at the moment.
Well, the Opta supercomputer has given Leicester City an 83% expectation of relegation now. And lose tonight, and I think it will be 95% or more. Their one ray of hope is the fact that their manager is one of only five in Premier League history to have kept a team up from as precarious a situation as this, with just two games remaining. Three seasons to go. Dean Smith's Aston Villa were 4 points from safety with three to go. But 5 points from their remaining three games in the running was enough to get them to leapfrog Watford and survive.
But there's a chance. And that's, you know...
You're telling me there's a chance.
Well, but that's what it is. If Leicester go into the last game, and they will, no matter what happens here, with a chance.
I suppose tonight gives you an indication of how good that chance is. If they lose, it's not a very good chance at all.
No, because
they draw,
confidence is
not
even
a great chance.
Confidence
if they
is
win,
even more, or lower than
they've got every chance.
Normally.
Yeah. Here is Iheanacho. Plays the ball across his own half of the field and gives it straight to Anderson. Anderson scurries towards the edge of the box. Isak takes over now, plays it down the left. Anderson delivers across, it takes a deflection, goes behind, it's out for a corner. And that's come about because of a sloppy pass from Kelechi Iheanacho. Barnes warming up down in front of us. And Newcastle warming players up too. It's 5 minutes before half-time. You're listening to Talk Sport. Here is the corner kick away to our left in front of the Leeds' end. Very difficult with Harry Suter in there. I mean, he's probably been deployed by Dean Smith because he knows just how good Leicester are... Newcastle are from set pieces. Ball sent into the box, pushed away by Everson, comes back out to the right hand side. The cross is deep. Byrne gets up there with a header. He's trying to keep it in here. He does. He's hooked in by Wilson. It cleared off the line. Wilson again, cleared off the line again. This time by the retreating Ndidi. And it's behind and away for a corner kick.
Wow, that's really got the crowd going. Two great opportunities. Where was the goalkeeper going? You just mentioned delivery superb. Newcastle keep it alive. Goalkeeper comes out.
Oh, he's hit the post from about 2 yards out, Wilson.
But he catches it, the goalkeeper, and throws it back into his own area. Look.
Corner again. Trippier to take it. Away to our left-hand side. That was a big, big chance for Newcastle United to take the lead. 40 minutes into the game. Wilson's hit the post on the volley. He's come back. He's headed the ball goalwards. And it's cleared off the line by Ndidi. Bit of pushing and shoving going on inside the six-yard box before this delivery comes in. Wide from the left-hand side. It'll be a right-footed delivery from Kieran Trippier. He sends it into the near post. It's flicked on. It goes through the six-yard box. Comes back out. Shoots Desher towards the edge of the six-yard box. It's blocked again. And then Almiron will try and travel down the right side before getting it back to Desher, who will get it towards the edge of the area. Here is Bruno Guimaraes trying to slide it down the right side of the box. There's a challenge by Iheanacho, which stops the momentum of the attack. And then Trippier has it inside the centre circle. He clips it down to the wall to the right, chested down by Scher. He moves forward, lays it off to Sean Longstaff, and then Longstaff comes infield. Up it goes into midfield, then back towards the edge of the 6 yard, the centre circle once again. And then it's with Bruno Guimaraes. He plays it out towards the left. On to Elliot Anderson. Anderson travels infield, being chased by Ndidi. Bruno Guimaraes forward to Trippier. Keeping hold of the ball well, Newcastle United. Leicester back behind the ball, trying desperately to defend, keep a clean sheet, which they haven't done since November. Ball chipped towards the edge of the area, headed down, comes to Almiron, right footed shot, hits the post again, Isak over the top of the crossbar from 7 yards out. Well, I don't know how it hasn't gone in, but it hasn't. They've hit the post twice now in this first half, and Isak knows that he's just missed a huge opportunity. As it came back off the post and into his path, it was almost certain to go in. It went a yard over the top of the crossbar. Lovely ball down the right channel, helped on by Cher into the path of Almiron. He got something on it. It bounced in front of the goalkeeper, who was nowhere near it, to be honest with you. And it hit the outside, inside of the post, came back towards Wilson. He miskicked it. That way it came through to Isak, and then he blasted it over the top.
It's a target, he scores, doesn't he? I mean, incredible, really. Again, good strike, Almiron. Digs it down and stuff. This reminds me of it like an Xbox game when I'm playing one of my kids, where I've got no idea what I'm doing, and I'm just pressing buttons,
bashing.
Yeah, and getting lucky.
Currently, Newcastle United 0, Leicester 0. And for the latest odds, you can head to Ladbrokes, where right now you can get Newcastle to win at 15-8 on, 13-2 the Leicester win, 23-10 the draw. That's all thanks to Ladbrokes. Play at ladbrokes.com, 18+, be gamble aware.
Only 13-2. Are they watching the game?
As you said earlier on, there's a chance.
And that's the thing. Sometimes, you know, they've got to ride your luck. Post has been hit twice already.
And they have ridden their luck, yeah, in the opening 45 minutes of this game.
It's nearly half-time and they're still in the game.
And before the World Cup, Leicester were in the Premier League top six for goals per game and shot conversion, despite a bottom five defensive record. Only an inability to hold on to leads was keeping them out of the race for Europe. But since the resumption of the season at Christmas, their performance in both attack and defence has declined. Only the Premier League high 13 points taken from losing positions has prevented them from relegation already. Here is Bruno Guimarães to the edge of the box, scooping it forward. It's behind Almiron, fast trying to take charge under pressure from Longstaff. Worked it wide out towards the right. We're in the final minute of the first half. Cross into the box by Trippier. Away by Castagna, out for a throw in midway between the edge of the penalty area and the byline, away to our left-hand side.
Again, it's just going to be an onslaught in the second half, isn't it? Slightly down the slope towards the Gallagher end. We might as well just turn our seats and face them down the hill.
Well, we've been facing this way the whole of this first half. Here is Trippier into the box towards Wilson. It's clipped off his toes by Johnny Evans, and it's behind and away for another corner kick right at the end of this first half. We've got 20 seconds of normal time to play. Across goes Botman to, is it Anderson, to protect the ball, and then he gives it to Trippier. Trippier places it on the edge of the quadrant. Longstaff is on the edge of the area, completely unmarked. There's not anybody within 20 yards of him. 3 minutes of added time. It's towards the back pass. Wilson with a header free over the top of the crossbar. Goalkeeper came and completely missed it again. And it was headed by Wilson over the top of the crossbar. And he can't believe he hasn't added to his magnificent goal tally.
He'd be very disappointed that he misses the target. It's a free header at the far post. Again, superb delivery from Kieran Trippier, bending into the far post. He's unmarked, he's free. And he's trying to guide it back towards the far post.
Could you explain what the goalkeeper's doing?
Well, that's twice he's come out and just completely flapped at things, isn't it? I mean, no, I can't, is the answer.
3 minutes of added time to play, of which we've played 40 seconds of the first of those. It's still 0-0 on TalkSport. The good news is that 60% of the 67 goals that Leicester have let in have come in the first half of matches. To get to half-time without conceding is a rare treat for Leicester City supporters, those of whom have made the journey.
But, you know, well, yeah, a minute or so from half-time, hit the post twice, a couple of
great chances.
Really good chances where not far out from goal, you start Leicester's night.
Here's Isak down the left-hand side, moving towards the edge of the penalty area, plays it wide onto Anderson. Anderson chops back, Isak wants it back again, get it inadvertently after a half clearance by Castagna. Then Anderson will get hold of it, tackled by Ndidi, away by Castagna, goes to halfway. Cher has it now. Remember, they only need a point, Newcastle United, to go to the Champions League next season. So this is fine by them at this moment in time. But the longer the game goes on, I suppose the more nervous people will get. Here's Guimaraes down the right-hand side into the path of Almiron. Almiron sends it to Trippier on the overlap. His cross is deep. It's over the head of Anderson. A little bit too deep this time. Isaac scurries to retrieve it. He's down the left side of the Leicester penalty area. On the attack, he comes in on his right foot. It's still 0-0. He gives it to Bruno Guimaraes on the edge of the D. More space for Almiron. Out wide right. He cuts in onto his left foot. He got a trip inside the penalty area there. The ball goes out towards the right, back towards Longstaff. Inside the box, he falls over. And then it goes out into the left fullback position, and Luke Thomas will clear. Just wonder whether or not if Almiron had been a little bit cuter and gone down, then there might have been a decision to make for Andre Mariner.
Yeah, possibly. Looked like a couple of players just slipped, though, as well, going into the area. Maybe the referee was aware of that, thinking, not quite sure. And of course, he's got the backup of VAR, knowing that they'll have a quick look at it.
Here is Dan Byrne, who's backing up Isaac on this left-hand side. He's run down into the left-wing position, giving it to Isaac, who's been pulled to the floor by Ndidi. He thought he was going to get a foul. He didn't, and now Ndidi is escaping over halfway. Bruno Guimaraes, who's got to be careful because he's already in a booking, sees the ball slid beyond him, and it's already black and white shirts everywhere before Vardy can get hold of the ball from Ndidi. And now they come forward, knowing that there's a couple of men the wrong side of the ball for Leicester. And here comes Almiron down the right side, the Paraguayan, who's darting beyond Sumare, gets to the edge of the box and lays it off to Trippier. Back in field it goes towards Cher. Cher looks up, there's no one really to aim at in the centre, so Trippier takes over now. We're into the final few seconds of added time, and there is the last action of that first half. First half in which Newcastle United have hit the post twice and seen Isak and Callum Wilson steer efforts over the top of the bar from very close range. Newcastle are heading to the Champions League and about to record their best points total since Kevin Keegan's first spell in charge. Leicester are inching above Leeds United as it stands, but will still be relying on beating West Ham and Everton dropping points on Sunday if they're to stay up, and it stays like this. They've had 17% of the possession, no shots on target, no corners in the first half. But it is Newcastle 0, Leicester 0.
Just watching Nick Pope walk in. He must be so bored. He's literally had nothing to do but watch a game of football. He didn't even buy a ticket. But the rest of the players going in, it's been so one-sided. It's been ridiculous here at St James Park. But it is 0-0. They've hit the post a couple of times. They've had some other good chances. Isak firing wide. Wilson heading over. A goal line clearance from Ndidi as well, but Newcastle on top, but without the goals to show for it. But points enough for them to secure Champions League football. A point will take Leicester above Leeds, but they will need a win on the final day of the season if they only get a point here at Newcastle tonight. They're certainly going to have to show more ambition than they have in the first half if they want to get the victory. One talking point from early on that mustn't be forgotten, Danny Mills, and that is Bruno Guimaraes. The foul on Sumare, it was studs at knee height. If the referee shows a red there, VAR would not overturn it, in my opinion. But referees, I think, are not showing a red. They'll show a yellow, thinking, well, if it is a clear red, VAR will change that and we'll get it right eventually. That's not how it works, though, is it?
No, I think that's a very good assessment. And this is what it's all been with VAR. It's a backup. I don't have to make a decision, because if it's a glaring mistake, they'll pick it up for me. So it's too easy sometimes for them to go, actually, I'll give a yellow, it's a foul. Having said that, I mean, I look at it, there wasn't a huge amount of force in it. He mistimed it and he caught him. It wasn't like he was going right through him. On the base, do you want to see players sent off that? I don't think it was nasty. It wasn't excessive force. It's a little bit late and it looks a little bit nasty. So probably a yellow is about right, but I think you're right. You know, and you watch a ridiculous amount of football. That's exactly what's happening.
Yeah, it's one of my big problems with VAR that the likes of Howard Webb do not address. They don't address that kind of thing, and that's the kind of thing that does need addressing. I don't think it would have changed Leicester's game plan. And let's talk about their game plan, which is basically to sit back, soak it all up.
I told you.
Harry Suter to head everything away if possible. And that's about it. The end of the first half, the possession stat, 83% for Newcastle, which is insane. But it is actually working for Leicester. And the job.
Well, it is.
Last 15 minutes, bring on Maddison, you'll win the game.
The ball boys have had more possession than Leicester. But what's the big stat that counts? 0-0. You know, and I said that gives them a chance. They need one moment. If they can keep, and they've ridden their luck.
Oh,
incredibly. But if they continue to do that, they need one moment. That's all you need. You just need a 5 second moment in the game where Vardy gets away, goal. Simple as that, job done. But a point is not a bad result. Are Leeds going to win against Spurs? Probably not, is the answer. If Everton get a point, let's say it's still 0-0 here, Leicester still have to win that last game, and that would get them out of it. So that's probably what they're back. They're going, if we get a point here, we've got just as much chance as actually, if they win here.
I did have a message from our TalkSport colleague Hugh Woozencroft, said all three are going to win on the final day. I mean, none of them are winning games. So how he thinks, if he's right, it's fair play to
him. I'll tell you what, I'll take that bet, Hugh. I'll message you later for the odds.
I mean, can't see Leicester winning anything.
I'll take his house off him.
Absolutely extraordinary. But listen, if that comes off, we've both got to apologise to him. It's 0-0 here, all Newcastle. As a Newcastle fan, I know Emma has just messaged me saying, how on earth are Newcastle not in front? Somehow it's stayed away from the back of the net. The keeper's been flapping, there's been chances that should have been taken, and the woodwork's been rattled as well. Leicester, though, are goalless here at Newcastle, and they will move up a place in the bottom three. You know, this is a season that's never ending. We've got more Premier League football for you on Wednesday night. I'll be at Brighton against Man City. What a celebration that will be. Stuart Pearce and Sam Matterface on commentary duty for that live and exclusive. And then the following night, there's another one. Thursday, Premier League, Man United against Chelsea. Nigel Adley and Dean Ashton with the commentary. Hugh Woozencroft will be your host at Old Trafford on that night. And all three playoff finals, all three European finals, live on TalkSport. We will be heading out to Prague with West Ham and to Istanbul with Manchester City as well. This is TalkSport, where the football never stops. Half time on game night, Newcastle somehow nil, Leicester nil.
Monday game night on TalkSport with Ladbrokes. Are you in? Let's go. Play at ladbrokes.com. 18 plus speedgambleaware.org.
And he's barreled it straight through the midfield into the Village Hotel pub and grill fan zone, the home of big screen live football. A long volley over the stadium seats by the giant screens into the left-hand corner of the bar. Past a winning lineup of ice-cold beers and a magnificent menu of mouth-watering footy food. Result!
Enjoy the perfect big match experience with food, drink and live football at a Village Hotel pub and grill fan zone at 33 UK locations. Find your nearest venue and win monthly prizes, including match tickets at villagehotels.com/fanzone. Get in! Conditions apply. 18 plus. Always drink responsibly.
Hello, my friend. Life comes at you fast, so make time for you time with Just Eat. For early times, lunch times, late times, strange times. The perfect times for the McDonald's sausage and egg McMuffin, Five Guys cheeseburger and strawberry shake, Domino's pepperoni passion, plus more from Costa Coffee, Cream's Cafe and Pizza Express. So order now, later, in a bit, whenever. We got it.
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Products subject to availability in restaurant and serving times. Participating stores only. See justeat.co.uk for details.
Rodri to De Bruyne. Flicked onto Walker. Goal! No one saw that coming.
Or as we say in Japan, no arutaka wa tsume o kakusu. The smart hawk hides its talents. For a taste beyond the expected, Asahi Super Dry, official beer partners of Manchester City. Enjoy responsibly. Visit drinkaware.co.uk.
For all the top Premier League analysis, listen to The Game, the Premier Football Podcast from The Times. Every Monday and Thursday, join Hugh Woozencroft and a host of big-name guests for in-depth reaction and opinion on the latest action and the biggest issues in the world of football.
It's a massive goal!
Hear previews of all the upcoming matches and provocative and compelling opinions from some of the finest football writers from The Times and The Sunday Times.
Lovely bit of football!
Listen to The Game on the free Times Radio app or wherever you find your podcasts.
We all fantasize about our perfect home, sipping a morning coffee out on the terrace. Good morning, Mr. Squirrel.
Morning.
The kids building a treehouse in the garden.
I'm living my perfect childhood.
But come on, this isn't real. Listen, if you're serious about making your fantasy a reality, find out what your home is worth instantly with a free online valuation estimate. Get real about moving. Get on the market.
Most common time to obtain an online quote between 1st of June 2022 and 30th of September 2022 was under 3 minutes. Excludes Northern Ireland.
We've got it at Selco. Selco, it's where the train goes.
At Selco Builders Warehouse, we've got real deals on a wide range of building products. In May, we've got 2.4 by 1.2 metre by 12.5 millimetre fireboard plasterboard for £11.49 ex-VAT. And with free delivery, that's a real deal. Find more real deals online at selcobw.com.
We've got it at Selco. Selco, it's where the train goes.
Charged at 20%. Free delivery within local delivery areas.
This football season, get a hand from Betfair's popular bet builder and easily add our fan favourite football selections to your bet slip in just one tap. Spend less time finger faffing and place your bet the easy way. Now that's handy, because we're Betfair.
Exclusive to Betfair Sportsbook. Terms and conditions apply. Please see frequently asked questions on support.betfair.com. 18+ BeGambleAware.org.
Sunday session on TalkSport with Now Sports. Stream all the Sky Sports action like Newcastle versus Leicester live tonight for £11.99. No contract. Search Now Sports 18+. Stream via internet. Terms apply.
Leave behind the workday blues. More live football on a Monday night.
What a chance! What a goal!
This is Game Night
on Talk Sport.
Game Night on Talk Sport with Car Finance 24/7. So it's Car Finance 24/7 today. It is Newcastle 0, Leicester 0. Newcastle with all the ball and with all the chances. A point though does mean Champions League football for Newcastle guaranteed. But they want to win. And I've got to say, when I worked in the bars here, the Tuxedo Royale, the boat under the Tyne Bridge with a revolving dance floor, Monday nights were always student nights in Newcastle, but I tell you, the big market will be rocking this evening if Newcastle United get the win and guarantee Champions League football next season. For Leicester, they'll stay in the bottom three with a point, but they will go above Leeds. They will, though, need a win on the final day of the season. Let's get the halftime odds with Ladbrokes.
Odds update on Talk Sport with Ladbrokes. Are you in? Let's go. Play at ladbrokes.com. 18+ BeGambleAware.org.
Jess O'Reilly from Ladbrokes. 0-0. Remarkably, unbelievably, inexplicably 0-0 at halftime.
I know, crazy. Over 80% possession from Newcastle, which on one hand is pretty pathetic from Leicester that they haven't really got out of their own half. But in fairness, on the other, they're doing the job that they obviously set out to do with the team sheet they have. 14 shots from Newcastle, just two on target. You've got to think, how long can they hold on for? They are very much surviving here. Not too much change in the match betting. Newcastle still odds on at 4-7. Leicester out to 7-1. And the draw is in there at 9-4. I don't see the draw myself. I do see Newcastle nicking it after that first half. You've just got to think they're eventually going to creak through. Newcastle to win 2-0 is around the 21-20 mark. I think that's where the play is now. And the 1-0 scoreline is in there at 19-5.
Jess, thank you very much. That's the latest odds with Ladbrokes. Play at ladbrokes.com. 18+. BeGambleAware.org.
Odds update on Talk Sport with Ladbrokes. Are you in? Let's go. Play at ladbrokes.com. 18+. BeGambleAware.org.
Well, they've just had some sort of shooting competition at half time, and some of those had Amanda Staveley's out there on the pitch as well. Some of those, she's had more of the ball than any Leicester player in that first half. She's kicked the ball more that Jamie Vardy did in that first half, but that's the Leicester game plan. Talk Sport Breakfast with Laura Woods and Ali McCoy from 6 a.m. on Tuesday morning. Tomorrow morning, the former Newcastle and Liverpool manager Graham Souness is among the guests. He'll tell you why he's swimming the channel. It's all for a good cause. Fair play to him, he's a good man. And when the breakfast show's done, stay with Talk Sport, because Ryan Jordan will be joined in the studio by rock star Noel Gallagher, of course, a big fan of the champions, Manchester City. He'll be absolutely lauding it tomorrow. Martin Keown this morning was sensational. He said he wanted to know why people were accusing Arsenal of bottling it, and if they were, why weren't they accusing Spurs of bottling their whole season? Martin, mate, they've developed a word for that. It's Spursy. Everybody talks about it. Come on. Join in. Catch up. You know what's going on. The halftime subs were warming up. James Maddison was out there, just went in a moment ago. Not too sure whether he'll be coming on or not. I can't see any changes being made this early by Dean Smith. Maybe later on when he might be pushing for a win if it is still 0-0, or if they do go behind and need to get back in the game. But so much possession for Newcastle United and so many chances as well, and it makes you wonder if Newcastle have to change their approach in the second half. Graham Jones just come out onto the bench from the coaching staff at Newcastle. He was involved in a big conversation, a lengthy conversation with Jason Tindall as the half drew to a close. Eddie Howe joined them as well, and you made you wonder whether they were thinking, does it need a different approach in the second half to actually make the breakthrough? Well, they've made chances, they just haven't converted those chances. And that late change as well, Joe Linton out injured and Elliot Anderson coming in off the bench and starting the game. I think he's actually played quite well. His grandfather, Jeff Allen, played for Newcastle United as well as a winger. That was in the 60s. He was actually in the squad. He didn't play. He was in the squad when Newcastle won the Intercities Fairs Cup in 1969. So, actually, there's a Geordie who's been on the pitch, who's got family history, trophy history with Newcastle United. Him and Longstaff coming through the ranks here. Longstaff's dad, a Great Britain ice hockey player. He's an ice hockey legend, without a doubt. And Longstaff's brother, a footballer as well. Matthew's been at Mansfield Town and Colchester United on loan in League Two in recent seasons. But we'll wait to get the second half underway. Officials are out there. The Newcastle United subs are still out there warming up, but we'll wait the players. Danny Mills, just wondering if Newcastle need to change their approach if they are to break the deadlock. We've got to remember they only need a point to guarantee top four.
Yeah, but I think they'll want to win here, and especially attacking the Gallagher end in the second half. You know, talk about it a lot. That slope does not get bigger when you're trying to defend it, and Leicester will find that. They'll do exactly the same thing. But I think they just need to be a bit more clinical. Newcastle, I suggest, would be the only real thing. Do they bring maybe Anthony Gordon or someone like that, or a dribbler that can maybe open something up? But there are so many bodies back there, it becomes very, very difficult. They get one, they'll get two or three.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and they are going down the hill, as you say, from the Leeses to the other end of the pitch to the Gallagher. So that will put the pressure on Leicester, who are just making their way out. Newcastle already out there. And I mentioned Elliot Anderson. You're talking about dark arts in the first half, maybe from Newcastle. Anderson will have learnt a bit on loan at Bristol Rovers under Joey Barton, who once compared him to Maradona. You want a dribbler? Maradona, Elliot Anderson, he's the dribbler. We've had everything from Newcastle in that first half, everything but the goals. It is Newcastle 0, Leicester 0, and Leicester have made that change. To tell you more about it, with the second half about to get underway, it's the former England defender Danny Mills alongside TalkSport's chief football commentator Sam Matface.
Madison is on, Iheanacho is off. And I think the idea was is that Iheanacho would provide the bullets for Jamie Vardy. That didn't really work out in the first half. Maybe Madison can come up with something that he couldn't. Newcastle shooting from left to right, immediately get us started and get moving very quickly into Leicester territory, and immediately the game takes shape as it did in the first half with Newcastle on the ball and Leicester defending deep.
Should we just turn to the right, Sam, and keep looking down that way?
Here is Almiron trying to get on the ball, beaten to it by Luke Thomas. Wilson comes across and puts it out. It's away for a throw-in. So Newcastle still got Pope in goal. Trippier, Scheer, Botman and Byrne. Bruno Guimaraes, who could have been sent off in that first half. Anderson and Longstaff. Almiron, Wilson and Isak. And then for Leicester, it's Iversen in goal. Suter, Evans, Fass and Castagne. Ndidi and Thomas. And then Tielemans and Samare, Vardy and Madison. TalkSport live at St James's Park, Newcastle in black and white. It's all blue for Leicester City. The floodlights on now, and the sky going dark as this area of the country finally succumbs to night time. This time of the year, it's very late before it gets dark in Newcastle. Here is Scheer up to halfway. On to Botman, wide on the left is Anderson, and then further wide is Alexander Isak, who comes infield, looks up, switches the play from left to right, gives it to Trippier. Trippier takes a couple of steps up towards the Leicester penalty area, goes wide now onto Almiron. Almiron trying to turn away from Samaro, plays a 1-2, gets it back from Bruno Guimarães, leaves it on towards Longstaff. He's just a little bit heavy with his pass onto Longstaff, and Iverson only had to come out a little bit to gobble up that ball and be cleared away. This is Talk Sport.
I mean, if it carries on this way, you know, the possession stats and the chances, it will be a minor miracle if Leicester don't concede.
That's what they need. They need miracles, don't they, at this stage of the season? And Newcastle United want to deliver for their fans that have been so good to them this season. This has been a historic Newcastle Premier League campaign. Those years of the entertainers really were kind of blips, I suppose, on the landscape for most of the Premier League era when you take it as a whole. Newcastle are, though, on course for their second best Premier League season based on points per game. The only one better than this was 94-95 when Kevin Keegan's entertainers took over 2 points per game, finished second, 78 points, 4 points behind the champions Manchester United, but they should have won it that year. Corner kick early in the second half then for Newcastle. After Byrne travelled down the left, it goes out of play. Kieran Trippier gets rapturous applause from the supporters in the corner of the East Stand and the Gallagher over on the far side, diagonally opposite us.
What a signing he's been, Sam.
Oh, brilliant.
The first signing, wasn't he? But, you know, and even myself questioned why he would sign.
Right, put it to the edge of the box. Space for Almiron. It hits the hands of Tielemans, no doubt about it. But was it too close? It comes out towards the near side. That's a high foot from Johnny Evans. And the referee is going to have to stop the game and have a look at the situation and consult with his assistant on this near side. First of all, it appeared to be a handball. I mean, no. I don't think that it's going to be given because it hits underneath the arm.
It hits
and
his elbow.
His back to it.
It hits his elbow, but his elbow is tight into his body. And the second one on Guimarães, the foot is high, but I don't think he makes any contact.
The referee has decided to play on. No more questions asked, and the Newcastle fans are starting to think that things are not going their way. We played 4 minutes of the second half. Newcastle won easily when these two met on Boxing Day. They haven't won the last. They have won the last two meetings between the two, but they haven't won three in a row against Leicester since '94. Here is Maddison playing the ball down through towards Vardy, but Vardy didn't have the ability to get on the end of that ball, and it's cleared away. And here's Trippier up over the halfway line. Maddison urged to get back and help out his team. Trippier back to Byrne, near side. Longstaff, sorry, not Byrne. Byrne's on the other side of the pitch. Here is Cher. He finds Byrne, who's just over the halfway line. He plays it down the left touchline into Isak. Isak runs up towards Castagne, who's backpedalling here. Isak delays and then comes back to the edge of the centre circle. Bruno Guimarães trying to move things out towards the wide right. It's on to Trippier, who's engaged by Samaré. Back to Almiron. Infield to plays a lovely 1-2 with Bruno Guimarães. Teases the ball into the box, cleared away by Johnny Evans, and it comes back on this near side. Jason Tindall acting as ball boy. Wants things moving quickly. Clap of the hands from Eddie Howe. Back to Jason Tindall again, who is trying to urge his team forward. Out to the right, wide right, and Trippier's got it for Newcastle. The ball's back in play under the floodlights at St James's Park. It's 0-0. Newcastle probing, they're prodding, they're trying to open up this back line, this stubborn back line of Leicester City. Over on the far side, Isak outpowers Castagne, goes towards the corner flag, turns. He's had so many touches of the ball in this game, Alexander Isak.
I think what we haven't mentioned, Sam, a win guarantees Newcastle third. You know, that's really important. I know it's not about Champions League qualification. The goal difference is ridiculous, Sam. They'd have to lose something like 20-0 in the final game. That ain't going to happen. So, you know,
Manchester United got to play on Thursday, though.
Oh, of course, they've got games left, haven't they? Yeah. Sorry, yes.
You went a bit early there.
Yeah, no, they won't win that. They'll lose.
They're playing Chelsea, Dan. Yeah. They're playing Chelsea.
Oh, okay, fair point.
Here is Bruno Guimarães.
But even still, they're going to want to finish third because that's important. And I know it's not about Champions League. You know, there's no qualification process. The top four go in automatically. But it's when you've been in this position, you want to say, we finished third in the Premier League.
Yeah. In order to do that, they need to definitely win the last two games. And they have this game and then their game against Chelsea on the final day of the season down at Stamford Bridge. Here is Bruno Guimarães.
But they securing Champions League was the aim, and they will do that with a point here tonight. Back in field to Fabian Scheer. They've been patient so far. They've created good opportunities and missed opportunities. Hit the post twice. Two sitters. Here is Longstaff inside the penalty area, under pressure, goes down. Claims of handball by the Leicester players saying that he illegally touched that, and the referee has allowed play on. Sent forward by Ndidi, but Vardy's still inside his own half of the field. There's no chance he's going to be able to race onto the end of that. He was doing the dirty work and trying to win the ball back previously. So it was a bit of a rushed pass by Ndidi forward.
Even he looks a bit downhearted, doesn't he, at the moment?
Who?
Jamie Vardy.
Yeah. Well, they all do.
But I mean, normally, if there's one player you'd expect out there to be like running around fighting for everything, it would be him.
A wave of noise sending Newcastle towards the Gallagate. Here is Bruno Guimaraes, right angle of the penalty area, away to our right-hand side. Gets the return ball from Kieran Trippier. This Leicester defence is holding firm at this moment in time. Slid forward by Scheer, onto Longstaff, right-footed shot, took a deflection, did it? No. Goes behind and away, wide of goal, out for a goal kick, away to our right-hand side. You're listening to TalkSport, and we're live at the home of Newcastle United, St James's Park, 52,152 in the stadium tonight.
Not a spare seat in the house, is there? I mean, it's incredible. Completely, it's pretty much always completely packed out here. Has been for the last few seasons. Magnificent support, even when they've been through tough times.
Yeah. Official capacity is 52,305, but there is quite a few seats that are taken out here tonight because of segregation. So that probably means every seat that is available has been taken. It's almost like getting gold dust trying to get a ticket now to get into the home end at St James's Park. Here's Isak down the left side, taken on by Bruno Guimaraes. Back to Isak again, now down by the corner flag. He travels laterally towards the edge of the penalty area. He's got Trippier waiting for the ball on the edge of the D. He goes instead to Botman, into Bruno Guimaraes. Scheer, now Trippier will get it. He's just right of the midpoint of the Leicester half of the field. Back to Botman, then on to Elliot Anderson. They're keeping the ball well here. 84% possession in the game for Newcastle United. 16 attempts on goal, 2 on target until this point, and 2 times they've hit the woodwork. Trippier into the penalty area, deep towards the far post, away by Castagna, funneling back into position, headed down. Samare smacks it into the air. Scheer is underneath it, vying with Vardy for the ball. Vardy gets the first contact on the ball, but Burns sends it back again. Poor ball forward by Ndidi, comes back to the right side, where it's collected by Trippier, onto Longstaff, onto Almiron. Almiron down the right, tickled away by Luke Thomas, out for a corner.
Leicester are camped 35 yards from their own goal. That's it. They're not even getting close to the halfway line at the moment. It's incredible. They're quite happy just to sit there, wait, see what happens. Newcastle just needs to be a little bit more clinical in and around the penalty area.
Trippier to take the corner in front of the Gallagher end. The first of the evening at this end of the ground. Right footed, sends the ball in towards the back post, away by Harry Suter, who I think has been placed into this team to deal with those set pieces from Kieran Trippier. Thrown in quickly from the far side by Guimaraes, and turned back by Anderson to Longstaff. Longstaff floats the ball out wide towards the right. Trippier keeps hold of it, chests it down, takes it on. He's got Scheer for company. Scheer flips it into the box towards Isak, away by Johnny Evans. Evans then picks up an E problem. Oh, gets back to his feet. Is he stretching out cramp there? I think he is stretching out cramp. Johnny Evans trying to get out from the back. He's got an issue. He's hobbling around inside the penalty area as the ball goes out towards the wide right. Trippier with the delivery towards the far post. Too heavy this time, goes behind. And Johnny Evans looks as if he's going to need some treatment.
That can't be cramp. He's not run more than 15 yards in the whole game.
It looks like he's stretching it out.
But he might have tweaked his hammy or something like that. But I mean, cramp, you've got to run around to get cramp. He's been camped on that box for, well, probably all but 1 minute of the game.
Yeah, he's gone down inside the area trying to run something off, that's for sure. He's had so many injuries, Johnny Evans. He's been out for so much of this season. Eddie Howe's just put on a jacket. It is chillier tonight than I expected it to be, bearing in mind I came up from Manchester where it was almost tropical today, actually.
Oh, even in Yorkshire today it was very, very sunny. But that's often the way, isn't it? This early sort of early warm sunny days, sun goes down, clear skies, temperature drops a little bit.
Yeah, I think I've come underprepared, I've got to be honest with you.
Well, you know, you've gone cream jacket early for summer.
It's nearly June.
Yeah, our summer, what, we get a week in August if we're lucky?
It's usually around this time that it's the hottest, isn't it? Which doesn't bode well going forward. 57 minutes gone, Newcastle 0, Leicester City 0, live on TalkSport. The ball is wide on the near side with Kieran Trippier. 0-0 the score. And lots of opportunities for Newcastle United, but no goals as of yet. Bruno Guimarães out towards Trippier. Trippier toward the edge of the penalty area. Now it's on to Almiron. Almiron trying to get through two blue shirts. The blue wall has certainly been erected on the edge of that penalty area away to our right-hand side. Can Newcastle find a way through? Can Newcastle pierce it? Trippier moves up towards the angle of the penalty area. Back to Cher.
I'd like to see Newcastle score, if for no other reason to see what Leicester do then.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, all I can think about this moment in time is Leicester needed so desperately to learn how to defend earlier in the season. Why didn't they just employ this approach right from the beginning of Dean Smith's tenure? Isak coming forward to share. He's got space for Trippier on this near side. Trippier moves up towards the edge of the penalty area. Back in it goes to Guimarães. It's all Newcastle United. Back to Almiron. Almiron trying to take on Samare and Thomas and then play it in between them to find Guimarães. Then takes over, gets it back. Almiron lays it to the edge of the area. Isak! Brilliant save by Iverson. It was too close to him. Isak's effort went curling towards the far post. It was probably a little bit too close to Iverson, who stuck up a right hand and popped it over the top for a corner.
Yeah, he was lucky. He was pretty much straight at him. Yeah, it was. It's just above his head. He's able to put an arm up a yard either side with that much power, and that's probably in the back of the net.
Good football though, wasn't it?
Oh, but it's far too easy, isn't it? They're just passing it around, no real pressure on them.
Trippier in towards the near post, going in was Botman for it, didn't reach it. It was forward to Wilson from Almiron. Now they're on the edge of the penalty area with Trippier once again. It's still 0-0. You're listening to TalkSport. We're approaching the hour mark. It's picked up by Bruno Guimarães, left hand side of the Newcastle attack. Isak again probing, prodding, trying to find a way through.
Leicester are playing, Sam, like they need a point to stay in the Premier League, aren't they? And they're just hanging on for dear life.
Here is Almiron down this near side, the right, onto Guimarães inside the area, trying to charge his way through. Maddison gets back, gets something on the ball. It spills to the left fullback position. Tielemans will clear it, but it's headed back by Botman. Collected by Longstaff, near touchline for Newcastle United. They have it for one, two passes, possibly Leicester, and give it straight back to the black and white jerseys, who are coming forward once again with Isak, moving towards the edge of the penalty area. Gets it onto his right foot, shot takes a deflection, goes over the top of the crossbar. Now the corner.
And listen to that roar. Crowd trying to wheel the ball into the back of net. I know you love a stat, Sam.
I do.
Have you got the stats, you know, territory stats in there? Because it must be about 95% in Leicester's half.
Inside opposition territory.
That's the one.
I'll get that for you in just a second. Hold on a second. Let me do this corner kick first of all, because it's taken short by Trippier to Almiron. The back heel didn't come off as he was trying to get it back to Trippier. And then Maddison and Tielemans are playing around these two. It goes out for a throw in on this near side. And I even think that's a Leicester throw. It's not. It's gone to Newcastle. It's played square now to Cher. Tielemans was still complaining about the throwing going the wrong way. Guimarães has got it back again. They're coming forward on this near side. Over towards the left it goes. It's picked up by Cher and smacked into the box. It's half cleared by Leicester City. Madison's got it, tries to draw a foul. Eventually it comes through to Samare. He's still on the edge of his own penalty area. Fast gives it back to his goalkeeper. The clearance by Iverson is into the air. And then Botman heads it away. Hoofed up into the night sky by Harry Suter. Flicked on.
I was going to say, it's a while since he played for Leicester, isn't it? Bob Hoof.
It's, yeah. Well, we've got 38 touches in the opposition box by Newcastle United. How many from Leicester?
None.
One.
Oh.
But Dakar and Barnes are coming on to add a little bit more threat.
To add a bit more defensive solidity.
Here's Isaac down in towards Byrne. On to Isaac again. Isaac inside the six-yard box, just couldn't get it back. And it's smuggled behind. It's away for a goal kick and a pat on the head for Ndidi. And here come the changes. So, who's going to come off here?
Vardy, I think.
Substitution for
Evans coming off for Dakar. That's the first change. And the second change is going to be Jamie Vardy off, Barnes on.
Well, Jamie Vardy's not really been in the game, has he? He hasn't been able to show that pace in behind. He has no service whatsoever. Even he looks not out of sorts. But it's almost like he's lost that little bit. Not lost a little bit of fight.
Well, I mean, Vardy
looks like there's confusion now. What sort of system they're going to play? Well, look, Vardy's just sort of put three up. Someone else has gone like four. I'm not quite sure they know what system they're going to play.
Yeah, they're arguing about it, aren't they? Down in front of us. And Dean Smith is putting his fingers up. Vardy hasn't quite come off the pitch yet. Dakar has had his instructions. Johnny Evans comes off the pitch as well. Wout Faes is talking to Luke Thomas and saying, I want... What? I haven't got a clue what's going on. Wout Faes has just shaken his head as if to say, what on earth is happening then? I don't get it. Who's playing right back?
It's charades going on. It's like, give us a clue. Is it a film?
Why is there so many midfielders? Here is Dakar down the left-hand side for Leicester, who move up towards the edge of the Newcastle penalty area. Maybe it will work. Here's Samare. Now he plays it wide onto Thomas. And Thomas plays it down the line into Barnes. Barnes trying to take on the Newcastle defence on the left-hand side. He wins the first corner of the game for Leicester City in doing so.
I tell you what, if Leicester manage to win this, it's like movie stuff, isn't it?
Well, look, Wout Faes has just come running over towards the near touchline. He's asking for instructions from Dean Smith just to get clarification as to what tactically they're trying to achieve. He's got his explanation. He's going back. John Terry's coming over just to make sure that everyone's on the same page.
But I've just seen there Dean Smith hold three fingers out. It's gone from three to two to four.
Well, we've got 27 minutes left to play. And Leicester have got their first corner of the game. Can they make the most of it? Nick Pope looks a dominant figure in that penalty area. It goes in towards the near post. It's headed away by Bruno Guimaraes and out towards the near touchline away for a throw. Tielemans' delivery wasn't the best.
Starting to get the feeling, though, that there could be a huge twist in this.
Listen, it's the Premier League. There's always twists. There's always plot twists that you can never even imagine. That's what makes it the addictive division that it is. It's why we cram around our radios, televisions all day, every day, looking for news and intrigue, and why we can't put it down. It's absolutely terrific.
I'll tell you what Nick Pope does very well, and he has his critics with his feet, doesn't he? He's not the greatest,
no,
but he throws it out very well.
He distributes with his hands well, yeah.
So rather than sort of roll it out and try and kick it, he's got a great overarm throw and an underarm one to get the attack going.
Here's Bruno Guimaraes clipping the ball forward down the left side. Isaac is on beyond the defence, but he can't keep it in because it's going to run off the turf and go behind and away for a goal kick away to our right-hand side. I wonder when Eddie Howe and Jason Tindall start thinking about the possibility of unleashing a wild card. They've got Jacob Murphy on the bench back from injury. They've got Alisson Maximan available to them. They've got Anthony Gordon, all possible wild cards up the sleeve.
A couple of minutes, I'd have thought. Keep looking around at the bench, keep talking to different coaches. How can we change it up? It's just not happening for them. It's just all, everything's almost at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah.
And this is the difference. Newcastle haven't been in this position before. Now, this is new to them. You have to be patient in terms of being at this stage of the season, you know, expectation of winning games, not to panic. Manchester United in the past, Liverpool, the Arsenal, Chelsea will believe that even if it takes 89th minute, they'll just keep playing and they will score that goal.
Yeah.
Newcastle, and because it's new to them, haven't quite got that belief when they're at this end of the table.
They haven't kept too many clean sheets recently. They kept 12 in their first 20 matches. And that's another thing that they would like to get back to. Maybe it's tonight that they keep a clean sheet for the first time in a little while, Newcastle United. Bruno Guimarães has it from Kieran Trippier as they come forward again inside Leicester territory. Leicester with everybody behind the ball once more. Trippier into Almiron. Almiron across to Sven Botman, who strides up through the centre circle. He's on the left side of the middle of the Leicester half. Everybody inside that final third now in the black and white jerseys. It's flipped out towards the far side. On to Isak. Now Guimarães. He's got Tielemans for company. He lays it back to Fabian Scher, who can hit them. He doesn't. Instead, he slides it down the right side of the area for Longstaff. Longstaff back to Scher. He's got Guimarães. He's going to hit it this time. It's going to curl towards goal, but too much elevation on it. And here comes Alan Saint-Maximin.
Yeah, Newcastle just getting a little bit frustrated, aren't they? Can't quite find the way through. Not really creating clear-cut chances anymore. Can this man make a difference?
Well, he has made the difference in previous matches. In fact, the last time he scored a goal, it was a 90th minute equaliser against Wolves in August. But he hasn't scored in 25 games. Off comes Saint-Maximin. On comes Saint-Maximin. Off comes Callum Wilson. Are you surprised by that change?
Yeah, a little bit. He hasn't really had too much service.
It means Isak will go down the middle and Saint-Maximin will go out wide towards the left. Interesting. Very interesting. Newcastle know that a point will send them to the Champions League next season. They'll have 70 points from 37 games. Liverpool can't catch them if it stays like that. Daka tries to cross on the left side. It goes behind and away for a goal kick. It stays like this at the bottom of the table. This is what it's going to look like. Leicester are going to go above Leeds on goal difference. It means that Leeds will have 31 points from 37 games, one to play, minus 27 goal difference. Leicester minus 18 goal difference, same points, same games. And Everton will have 33 points from 37. They will need still to win on the final day of the season to ensure that they get a place in the Premier League next campaign. They play Bournemouth. Leicester entertain West Ham. Leeds entertain Tottenham at Elland Road. They will have to win.
I know Hugh Wilson-Croft thinks all three will win. I think one will win. I think there'll be a win, a draw and a loss out of those final three games.
Yeah? You want to tell us which ones?
I know what I hope for.
Everton.
I'm not saying.
I'm being unbiased.
Yeah.
Newcastle 0, Leicester 0, and for the latest odd, heads to Ladbrokes, where right now you can get Newcastle to win the game at 11-10 on, 10-1 for Leicester to win the match, 6-5 the draw. It's all thanks to Ladbrokes. Play at ladbrokes.com. 18+, begambleaware.org. Do Premier League players take a drop if they go into the Champions League in terms of wages?
Championship, you mean?
Championship, sorry, yeah.
Some will. Yeah. Some have in the past, but the problem is in this.
Wout Fast has slipped over on the halfway line playing the ball forward.
But the problem is in this day and age, Sam, players are going to go, if I'm coming to your football club, if we go down, you're going to get a 25% wage reduction. They'll just go, I'm not signing it.
Here is Elliot Anderson out towards the left. Saint-Maximin with his first touch of the ball. A burst of electricity goes around the stadium as he plays the ball into Guimarães. Takes a lucky deflection onto Longstaff, who helps it back to Kieran Trippier. It's 20 minutes before the end of the game and it's still goalless on TalkSport. I don't think many people would have predicted that at this stage, but then Leicester are playing eight defenders. The ball's out on the left-hand side. Anderson just about keeps it in, plays it against Madison, is out for a corner. Anderson looks as if he's feeling the pace of the game. He's now touching the back of his hamstring as we get to this late point of the season, which is taking its toll on so many players. It's been a long season. Newcastle have just got one tiny hurdle to jump over. If they can get a point from this game, then nothing else will matter to them. If they get all three, they'll be smiling from ear to ear. It's been a terrific campaign for them. Jacob Murphy's about to get ready and come on for Newcastle. Trippier, ball right underneath the crossbar, and he's flicked off the post again. Flicked on at the near post, and it hit the far post. It might have gone all the way through. And now Longstaff is under pressure, and he's done brilliantly to get away from Madison and Daka. And Almiron will just keep the ball in on this near side. He plays it forward. Scher draws the foul from Thomas. Free kick given. How's that not gone in?
How's that not going in? Where's even the goalkeeper going? He's ended up and he's got himself tangled up in the back of the net. That, I mean, it comes out as a great set piece yet again.
Right underneath the goalkeeper. It took a little flick of Boutfass. And then...
That's Guimaraes.
It's Guimaraes who heads it against the post from less than 1 yard. Here is Alisson Maxima into the penalty area. Oh, two players getting each other's way. Longstaff and Isaac. And the ball spills out of the penalty area. But Trippier intervenes. He's picked it up. He slipped it down the side of the box. Here's Almiron. Plays it through the centre. Blocked by Fast. Goes behind. And it's away for another corner.
It's absolute chaos in there now. Leicester all over the place. Newcastle almost trying too hard to score. Getting in each other's way.
Now Longstaff and Isaac really did get in each other's way there. They almost kicked each other's feet. The ball's with Alisson Maxima once again. Moves down the left-hand side. Beats Castagna. Then tees it up towards Anderson. Anderson who drives it, gets right underneath it and blasts it over the top of the crossbar.
Do you know what Sam, it reminds me of a team when they've got 9 men on the pitch. And there's no ambition whatsoever to move off the edge of the six-yard box.
That's the third time tonight that they've hit the woodwork.
Do you know what? He sees the post and he pulls out of it a little bit. I think he gets a little bit scared at the far post. He realises if I go right through this, I could headbutt the post.
And knock myself out.
Yeah. Got to be braver than that, lad, back post. Alan Shearer would have done it. Just anything for a goal.
Would you have done it?
Not too right. I'd have dented the post. No sense, no feeling.
0-0. Newcastle have come so close to getting the goal.
Three times the post?
Three times they've hit the post. Wilson over, Isak over when they should have scored. They've been so unfortunate. That goal's led a charmed life. I don't know how, because Daniel Iverson has missed about three balls into the box, come completely flapping for it and got nowhere near it.
But Dean Smith now starts to think, you know what? 16, 17 minutes to go. This might be our night.
They might get a point. I don't know if that constitutes being their night,
well,
but they might get a point.
It gives them a chance, doesn't it? Or gives them a better chance. It
gives them a better chance, yeah. Than not winning, yeah.
Because even if Everton then pick up a point and Leicester win, they go above them. Because the goal difference is far better.
Yeah. But they're relying on Everton at home dropping points against Bournemouth on the final day. So it's not in their hands. There will be drama, there's no doubt about that, and you'll be able to follow it all on TalkSport and TalkSport 2. Probably a good idea to download the app if you haven't got it. You can flick between the two stations. You can also listen back to some of our great programmes that we put out on a day-to-day basis, like White and Jordan this morning with Martin Keown, who again was fascinating. Absolutely fascinating to listen to every single time he's on the radio with those boys. And it was a good listen again this morning. And tomorrow they've got Noel Gallagher in the studio with them, White and Jordan, from 10 o'clock. Here is Trippier into the penalty area. Away by Fass, comes out to Bruno Guimaraes. He picks it up, lays it back towards Cher. Down the right it goes. It's collected by Almiron, who plays it infield. Scooped up into the air. Fass away. And it bounces on the edge of the box and Trippier sends it infield. Guimaraes back towards halfway. It's collected by Cher. Infield to Bruno Guimaraes again. He turns it forward. Oh, he slips. He plays it for on. But Isak has the presence of mind to steer it out wide towards the left. And now Sam Maximan, who gets to the edge of the penalty area, gives it to Guimaraes, who turns and plays it back to Trippier. They're all packed on the edge of the box. It's difficult to pick a way through. It's into the box for Almiron. It's away by Fass, who stepped in front of the Paraguayan. But it's all Newcastle United.
It's the most one-sided 0-0 I've ever seen in my life.
Ball is on the left-hand side. It's played infield to Alan Saint-Maximin. Saint-Maximin plays it wide towards the left-hand side. So they continue to come forward here, Newcastle United. We've played 75 minutes of this game. Ball out wide towards the right. Trippier through the legs of the defender. Onto Longstaff. Drives it goal. Was stopped by Iverson down the right-hand side. And it continues to be one-way traffic. 83.2% possession to Newcastle United. They've hit the woodwork three times. They've had some cracking chances. They haven't converted one yet. Guimaraes down the right. Onto Trippier. Slipped by Thomas. Into the box. Across towards the far post. Is it coming in? It comes back towards the edge of the box. And Almiron's effort. He couldn't keep it down. He collides with Ndidi. It's going to be a goal kick away to our right-hand side. And Jacob Murphy's going to come on. This is Talk Sport.
What are the odds on the draw, Sam? I think I might...
What was it, 13-2 or something?
6-5. That was about 10 minutes ago, though. So it's probably even tighter than that now, shorter than that now, as we take another drinks break here. And I can tell you that tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock, Laura Woods will be back on Breakfast. Graham Souness is going to be on the show, the former Newcastle manager. He's going to talk about swimming the channel. He'll also reflect on this game with the guys. White and Jordan from 10 have got Noel Gallagher with them. And remember, we've got more live football for you on Wednesday night as Brighton take on Manchester City. That's live on Talk Sport. Adrian and I will be there down on the south coast for that one. And then Thursday night, it's Manchester United against Chelsea. Nigel Adderley, Hugh Woozencroft and the gang will be at Old Trafford for that one. Elliot Anderson has come off for Jacob Murphy. Over the weekend, all the playoff finals are on Talk Sport and Talk Sport 2. And we've got the final day of the WSL. And we've got the final day of the Premier League on Sunday, 4:30 kickoff. You're listening to Newcastle versus Leicester live on TalkSport with Now Sports. Don't forget, with Now Sports, you can stream all the Sky Sports action like Newcastle versus Leicester live right now, £11.99. No contract. 12 minutes to go. Newcastle doing everything they can to get in front, but they haven't breached Daniel Iverson away to our right-hand side just yet. Same Maximat. On to Bruno Guimarães.
It's a Leicester Mourinho performance, isn't it? Just park as many buses as you can and hope for the best.
I don't think I've seen this many buses since I was walking down Seven Sisters Road on the way to Tottenham.
But I mean, there's been no ambition whatsoever from Leicester. I mean, I said at the start, you know, from the lineup that they had, I thought it would be seven players behind the ball and they'd launch it long. They haven't really, apart from the first 5 minutes, they haven't really launched it long.
Well, they seem to be happy with the point. They think this is a good result for them. Okay.
But this is what I said. It's like they're playing, like a point keeps them in the Premier League.
I'm not sure that it is enough.
No, I know it's not, but that's the way like they're playing at the moment, isn't it? It feels like this is the last game, and if they get a point, they stay up.
Listen, they've done their calculations. They obviously have worked out that they think they've got a better chance with a point than not. So, good luck to them. Here is Longstaff over on the left-hand side. Plays it to Sam Maximan, who runs at the angle of the edge of the penalty area. Madison coming back at him. Plays it into Guimarães. Oh, there was space on the near side for Trippier, but someone came back and nabbed it. It was Patson Daka who got it away, but only as far as Sam Maximan, who once again goes swashbuckling towards the edge of the penalty area. Plays the ball down the left channel. It's blocked this time. Comes back to Madison. Almost repelled into the path of Isak. He didn't quite get hold of it, and they're waiting in front of the goalkeeper to pick the ball up and clear it away. 79 on the clock now. Dean Smith getting a little bit more pensive. I wonder if it stays like this. 83% possession, 23 shots, 4 on target, 11 corners. If that right at the end of the game, when there's a set piece, and Leicester's propensity for set piece concession is pretty high, whether Nick Pope is allowed to come up and join the fray. He hasn't got anything else to do. Here's Longstaff, slipping it down the left channel, looking for Isak, who's going to get there ahead of Wout Fast. He's down by the touchline. He's engaged by Castagna, and the goal kick is given. Andre Mariner seem to be following that.
Right, as a defending team, Sam, you now get to 80 minutes, and you start to believe you can get a point. But there are certain markers in the game that you think we get to.
Do you get like to an 80. Extra win?
Oh yeah, without a doubt. You get to 80 minutes and you think, you know what? Just dig in now for 10 minutes. We can kick the ball out of play and waste 4 or 5 minutes just by hoofing it in the stands.
Do you think that Leicester should have started to employ this sort of tactic then earlier in the season? Like, go back 2 or 3 games? Why not?
Start a season. If you draw every game 0-0, you stay up. Simple as that.
But what I mean is, Dean Smith has got the reputation of someone who can drill a defence. Obviously, this defence has been drilled to play like this today. Why did they not do that for the games against Everton, for the games against Liverpool, for the game against Fulham down at Craven Cottage? If they'd done that, they wouldn't be in this situation.
Because, and especially, you're right, because the players that they've got, the attacking prowess, they're always likely to nick one somewhere.
Here is Trippier in the right fullback position. I just wonder if it's just a little bit too late now. Here is Cher coming forward, fouled by Samare. And it's going to be a free kick in the right fullback position, played into Botman on the edge of the penalty area. He's played it out to the wide left, and it's now with Byrne. Byrne moves up towards the left side. Alan Saint-Maximin comes to the halfway line, looks up, wanted to release Almiron or Isaac. Murphy's now on this right-hand side. It's almost like a 4-2-4 for Newcastle United, because they've sort of vacated the midfield area because they haven't required it for most of the game. Here's Bruno Guimarães, who seems to be playing in there on his own at this moment in time. Longstaff's broken the lines and gone down the left-hand side. And Didi's just dived on the floor. I don't think you can really just do that and expect to get away with the ball. He's then had to give it to Castagna, who's cleared it away. It's gone upfield. Dakar's got the pace to chase it, but Kieran Trippier has lifted it over his head. Taken down by Byrne. And they've got some space over the halfway line. Trippier, Guimarães, centre circle. Newcastle on the attack. Newcastle fans a little bit frustrated. Have they got the ingenuity to find a way through this tightly packed Leicester defence, this blue wall that's been amassed on the edge of their own penalty area, having had no shots on target at all? Here is Bruno Guimarães, and only 17% of the ball. Here's Bruno Guimarães again, flipping the ball into the box. It's going to be tossed behind by Castagna under no pressure, and that seemed negligent. Are they going to make them pay for it?
Have they even had a shot, Sam?
I mean, no shot.
Yeah, no shot.
No shot on target. Not even a shot. It's been a very limp attacking display, but they have managed to keep Newcastle at bay up until this point. There's 7 minutes to go. You're listening to Talk Sport. They've hit the woodwork three times, Newcastle. Trippier in towards the near post, headed away by Castagna towards the far side. It goes out for a throw-in, and they want the ball back quickly, Newcastle. They want to get things going. There's got an urgency about them now, even though a point is enough for them. They get to the Champions League with a point. They don't need to win this game, but they want to win this game. That's the difference between the two teams, I think. Here is Trippier over on the far side. There's a rigidity about Leicester that has been missing all season. They haven't kept a clean sheet since November. Here's Trippier moving towards the edge of the box again. Didn't decide to put the ball in the box or give it back to Saint-Maximin. He's gone wide to Bruno Guimarães, who's travelled down the near touchline. He felt he was fouled. The referee doesn't give the free kick, and Leicester are able to bring it away. Tielemans up towards the halfway line. Byrne dabs it back. Trippier's got hold of it now. Right side into Longstaff. Byrne had moved to left back position to right back position there. Longstaff's ball's not going to reach Alan Saint-Maximin. The clearance by Castagna is going to reach Maddison. He comes forward, travels with it in towards the centre circle, twirls away from Longstaff and moves out towards the wide right position. And there's a bit of an attack going on for Leicester City. Oh no, they've gone back to the halfway again.
Nosebleeds, and it got over the halfway line, panicked. Now what do we do?
Samare travels down the left. It's collected by Tielemans in centre field. He looks up, plays it back to halfway, bout fast. So they need to come on and push a little bit further up the field here, Newcastle, and try and rob the ball high up. Here is Harry Suter, slides it down the right side, collected by Castagna. Castagna travels in field. Ndidi's got it. Tielemans now. They're still only 10-15 yards over halfway. They're not getting anywhere near the Newcastle penalty area. Maddison drops deeper to pick the ball up. 5 minutes to go, 0-0. Live on TalkSport. It's not enough for Leicester to get excited about, because Everton will still have a huge points advantage. Remember, if Leicester win this game tonight, by the way, they move out of the relegation zone. And safety will be in their own hands on the final day. They draw tonight. Safety is very much out of their hands. They need Everton to drop points, and they need to win against West Ham at home. Here down the left-hand side is Barnes. Back to Thomas. He's got Samare square of him. He plays the ball to the edge of the area. Maddison in a little bit of space. Can he conjure something? A bit of magic for Leicester. Samare moves up towards the edge of the box. On the left-hand side is Thomas. It's a rare, sustained period of Leicester City possession. And the Newcastle just surrendering possession for the first time in the match, really. Dropping deep towards the edge of their own penalty area now.
Just watch them nick a goal or get a penalty or something ridiculous now.
Leicester?
Yeah, free kick, edge of the box, Maddison. Puts one in.
Thomas.
It's just been one of those nights, isn't it?
Barnes into Samare, trying to get away, onto Tielemans, plays it left, and a big right foot comes out from Scher to stop it from reaching Barnes, and Newcastle United now try to bring it clear, but Murphy's giving it back to Dakar. Dakar into the penalty area, away by Byrne, and now Isak waited too long for the ball, and Samare went across and won it. Maddison turns it over, looks up, plays it into the box, sort of, goes over everyone's head and goes out of play. And out comes Dean Smith screaming at everybody, Craig Shakespeare, get back into shape, get over this side. Indeed, he's gone down, he needs a bit of attention. And we're into the 87th minute of the game, and it's still goalless on Talk Sport. Arguably, Dean Smith will be the happier of the two managers in terms of performance and what it has generated in terms of outcome. But overall, this will be enough to take anyhow to the promised land, and that should be welcomed by this crowd that have tried to roar their team onto victory. Anthony Gordon comes on for Almiron for the final few minutes of the game.
It's going to be interesting to see what Dean Smith says in his after-match press conference. You know, surely he's got to be asked, was there no ambition to go and win the game? You know, do you think a point here is enough? That they're banking on Everton only getting a draw and then winning on the last game of the season.
Yep, that's what they're doing. They're hoping that that is enough. And the problem with that is what if that doesn't happen?
No, I completely agree.
So if that doesn't happen, then you've decided not to try and win this game and sacrifice your place in the Premier League.
Whereas if... I guess they're assuming that... They're assuming that Everton will get a point last game. That's what they're banking on, isn't it? No, but that has to be. That has to be the thought process.
How can you just decide that that's going to be the case? I don't really get that.
Well, they've shown no attacking intent whatsoever. Like you said, they've not even had a shot. I was going to say, if you don't shoot, you don't score. That's not true. When I was at Middlesbrough, we beat Man City 1-0. Sonji High scored an own goal for City. We never had a shot.
Indeed, he's coming off, and Mendy is coming on. We're into the final few seconds on TalkSport. Newcastle 0, Leicester 0, with Car Finance 24/7. Search Car Finance 24/7 today. Newcastle, it'll be enough for them. They will have new Champions League heroes next season, new memories to make. They beat Juventus here in 2002, played Barcelona, drew with Inter, won against Leverkusen. Schola Amiobi scored in the Nou Camp. And they're going to get some big teams because of their coefficient. So it'll be interesting to see who gets to visit this vibrant atmosphere, this cathedral of football. Halfway line, the ball is at the feet of Dan Byrne. 0-0 the score. There are two sides to this story. Leicester played in the Champions League just 6 years ago, but they will be relying on Everton failing to beat Bournemouth in order to have any chance of staying in the Premier League. And they'll still have to beat West Ham at the King Power Stadium. Can you trust Leicester to pull it out of the bag? A team that were on course for a 43-point season based on their points per game before the World Cup. It's been a serious decline after the World Cup, an undulating season of pain. They started badly, got better, got worse, and then gradually got even worse. They never really started keeping clean sheets all season, really, but they haven't kept one since November. If they keep one here, they'll get a point. Is that enough? Well, maybe you should give the boys a call on the sports bar, 0371 722 3344. They'll take your calls. 5 minutes of added time at the end of the 90. There'll be a lap of appreciation at the end of this game to celebrate the Champions League party. They'd like to do it with a late winner. You never know. There's still time. Iversen clearing the ball away. Byrne forward. Suter goes across to reach it. Isak now challenging. The ball's cleared upfield by the Australian. Over towards the far side. And eventually it'll be nudged out of play by Botman, who was taking no chances there. And they want to get things started, Leicester City, because Maddison wants to get on the ball. He's won a free kick over on the far side. And now a chance possibly for Leicester to try and pinch it right at the very end in injury time. Danny Mills,
told you. I mean, this would be the greatest, well, they'll pretend it's the greatest tactical game of all time if they nick this, won't they?
Maybe it is.
Well, they've been lucky as.
That's we what said, we have to say. We said when the teams came out that that may well be what they were designing. We said it was a risky strategy. So far, they're coming away from here with just a point. If they could get all three, they'll move out of the relegation zone. Free kick, far side, injury time. We've played a minute and a half of five that are added. Over on the far side, 2 yards in from the right touchline. Leicester City got Harry Suter up from the back, trying to cause chaos with his height. They don't deliver the ball first time. They play it wide down the right-hand side instead. It goes back to Soumaré, and they still haven't got it in the box. It goes back to the wide right. Maddison into the penalty area. It's hit by Castagna, and it's saved brilliantly by Pope down to his right-hand side. Castagna's effort from Maddison's cross, and Pope pulls off a world-class save, moving down to his right to keep it at 0-0.
What a save that is. Leicester so unlucky. I thought they were messing about on that far side with a free kick. And in the end, it's a great ball in from Maddison. A decent volley. Pope's lucky it's close enough to him. Oh, another foot and he can't reach it.
He's had nothing to do all night and he's made one magnificent save to save the game. Ball cleared away, but only as far as Soumaré. Now it's Newcastle who can't get out of their own half. And it's Leicester who are looking for a late winner. Datka down the left, heads the ball in towards Barnes. Almost comes through to Maddison, away by Byrne, upfield towards Isak. He can't make it stick now. Soumaré gets it back to Luke Thomas. He's rushed by Murphy. The ball goes down the left-hand side. Datka is chasing. Pope's come a long way, and Pope is going to get there. And they want to get it forward again, the Newcastle fans. Jason Tindall telling Alan Saint-Maximin, come on, raise your game. There's one more big puff of breath.
See this through. 2 minutes to go and they will be in the Champions League.
Castagna's unlucky because it's in and around Pope. It's a good save, but I would say it's a save of a keeper of that calibre that you'd expect him to make.
Oh, the reaction time was short.
It's fabulous. But it's in and around him. If that goes in, you're asking questions of the goalkeeper.
I tell you what. That was a moment of high drama right at the very end of this Premier League game, which has been all Newcastle United. They've had one shot on goal. That was it from Castagna. They fired that bullet. And Nick Pope, as he so often has been the shield for Newcastle. Free kick, right full-back position for Newcastle. They're happy to waste the time now and take the temperature out of the game because they know their job is done. No point in risking it. No point in risking it. Because if they lose here, all of a sudden they become vulnerable on the final day to Liverpool snatching their place in the Champions League. Yeah, it would take a lot. But you never know. The way things stand at this moment in time...
When I said you never know early on, you all laughed at me.
No, you said you never know. It hasn't happened, Dan, just to be honest with you. Well, Leicester haven't won the game.
But you didn't expect this to happen, did you?
Well, listen, I think we're more expecting of a 0-0 than we were of a Leicester City victory, bearing in mind they've played pretty much eight people behind the ball since the start of the game.
Oh, 9.5 at least.
Everton against Bournemouth, Leeds against Tottenham, Leicester against West Ham, the final day games. Gordon flicks the ball on, but it's going nowhere, and it's into the arms of the goalkeeper, Iversen. We're into minute... Well, we've played 5 minutes of added time. Newcastle United just about to secure Champions League football. Leicester still with work to do to stay in the Premier League. Still with a lot of work to do and hope. They've got to hope that Everton drop points on the final day of the season if they're going to stay in the league. A draw takes Leicester above Leeds. They'll be relying on Everton losing or drawing in the final day against Bournemouth, and they will have to win against West Ham. They'll have to hope that West Ham are distracted by Europe. This crowd's distracted by Europe because Newcastle are going into the top four, securing a position in the top four. The full-time whistle blows. For the first time in 20 years, Newcastle United are a Champions League club again. They will be playing in club football's premier competition next season, thanks to a magnificent season, a season that saw them go to a cup final, ride the blip of the first 3 months of 2023 and come roaring back to claim a place at Europe's top table. Eddie Howe, Jason Tindall, Kieran Trippier, Bruno Guimaraes,
The whole team rejoice. St James's Park is rocking with jubilation. This is where they think they belong. This is what they crave. Through the dark times, through the Ashley era, Que Sera Sera is sung with gusto around St James's Park. But Leicester's Premier League status is still alive. A backs-to-the-wall performance, which means it has a pulse. It's a weak pulse, but it's just about there. They have to hope Everton mess up at home on Sunday, and they have to beat West Ham. It means Leeds are increasingly likely to drop to the Championship. Whatever happens, it will be some final day, and it will all unfold on TalkSport. Newcastle 0, Leicester City 0.
The flags are flying again, the fans celebrating. They knew just before that final whistle, Champions League was assured. And if you'd said to them at the start of the campaign, you'll finish top four, they'd have absolutely grabbed your hand off. Yeah, I'm not quite sure what we've all witnessed here tonight. It certainly wasn't a game of football. We'll get into that shortly. But the outcome is that Newcastle United will be mixing it shoulder to shoulder, toe to toe with Real Madrid, Bayern Munich, Barcelona and co. next season in Europe's top club competition, the Champions League. They're back there after 20 years in the wilderness away from the Champions League. Newcastle under Eddie Howe have gone back to the big time, and he had a massive smile on his face at the end of the game. Yep, they didn't get the result they wanted, but they got the point they needed to get into the Champions League. As Leicester come off the field after applauding their fans up in the top tier in the Leases, James Maddison first down the tunnel. He was on for the second half. Yuri Tielemann following him. Harvey Barnes a second half sub. Harry Suter headed so many balls away tonight. Incredible. They finally had an effort on goal, and what an effort, and what a save from Nick Pope. But that was the exception that proved the rule, that Leicester didn't want to play tonight. They didn't want to win tonight. What they wanted to do was go above Leeds in the bottom three, and that's exactly what they've done. So it looks like this down at the bottom. Southampton are bottom and relegated on 24. They've gone. Leeds on 31 with a goal difference of minus 27. Leicester on 31 with a goal difference of minus 18. Everton above the dotted line on 33 with a goal difference of minus 24. So Leicester and Leeds have to win to have any chance of staying up. Everton beat Bournemouth, they're safe, and they send Leicester and Leeds down. If Everton draw and Leicester win, then Leicester will be safe. Their goal difference is far better. Leeds Spurs, Leicester West Ham, Everton Bournemouth on Sunday, final day, and it's all getting heated down there. One of them will be happy, two of them will be going. But Danny Mills, what exactly have we just seen in front of us for the 90 minutes tonight? I mean, can Leicester really be happy with that?
But they've gone to their fans, punching the air, hugging each other. It's almost like they're celebrating a win, isn't it? I mean, it's absolutely bizarre. Okay, they've got a point. They've given themselves a slightly better chance on the last day of the season. They've got to win, simple as that. They're obviously banking on that, and then they're praying that Everton don't win and only pick up a point at Bournemouth. It's a massive gamble, I think.
But it's clearly, huge, isn't it? Yeah. Clearly, a win would have taken them out of the bottom three.
And then it's in their own hands.
Yeah.
And they never had any... And almost, if you're going to go down that route, you'd have said, actually, You might as well gamble tonight. Go for the win. If you lose, you're still gonna have to win the last game of the season.
Yeah.
And then you're still hoping at the other end of the table. In the other games anyhow. So, but they've celebrated almost like they've won the game. But do you know what I was trying to say in commentary? It's almost like they've come here with the impression that this is the last game of the season, and if they get a point, they stay up.
It's mad. I don't really understand it. Listen, if it works out on Sunday for Leicester, fair play, but I'm a bit confused by the whole game plan, really. But listen to this. The Newcastle fans are staying behind to show the appreciation to their players. It's all smiles down there, right in front of us. We're yards from the dugout, but they're all smiles. They're in the Champions League, Newcastle.
Huge congratulations to Newcastle. You know, fabulous. I know there was a lot of conjecture when the new owners came in. they haven't spent absolute fortunes. Yes, they've spent money, and they've got every right to do that, but they've spent it very, very wisely. From where they were when the new owners came in and Eddie Howe came in, all you can do is stand up and applaud Newcastle, because they have been absolutely magnificent. And I think not just in the way that they've played, the way that the team, the manager, the coaches, they've all conducted themselves, you know, through this process. You know, all you can do is just stand up, applaud and say, well done, Newcastle.
Yeah, and that's exactly what the fans are doing here in St James Park. This place will host Champions League football, and they're going to get big boys early on in the competition as well. Fantastic time for these fans. They're going to enjoy every second of the celebrations tonight, no doubt about it. You are going to get reaction to this match from the Newcastle manager Eddie Howe and the Leicester boss Dean Smith, who is hit with his explanations and rationale. That's in the sports bar once we've finished.